the nicest. Nobody touched me in a righteous. Nobody text me in a crisis. I believed all of your dreams are duration. You took my heart, all my keys, and my patience. You took my heart, I must leave a decoration. You mistaken my love, I brought for you for foundation. All that I wanted from you was to give me something that I never had. Something that you never seen. Something that you never been. Mm-hmm. But I wake up and nothing's wrong. Just get ready for work, 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 work. To me, I be work, 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 work. You see me do me dirt, 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 dirt. Tell me about that work, 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 work. Na, 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 na. When you walk out, na, 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 na. Before the table turn, 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 turn. Beg you something, please. Baby, don't you leave. Don't leave me stuck here in the streets. If I get another chance to, I will never, no, never neglect you. Against you, I just hope that it gets to you. I hope that you see this through. I hope that you see this through. What can I say? Please recognize I'm trying, baby. I feel why, you send me up there, why. You see me do my da 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 da. So me better why. When you walk out, la. When I care for my touch.
Yeah. Get done at work, come over. We just need to slow the motion. Don't get out of way to no one. Long distance, I need you. When I see potential, I just gotta see it through. If you had a twin, I would still choose you. I don't wanna rush into it if it's too soon. But I know you need to get done if you come over. Sorry if I'm way less friendly. I got niggas trying to end me off. Yeah. I spilled all my emotions tonight, I'm sorry. Rolling. How many more shots until you're rolling? We just need a face to face. You could pick the time and the place. You spend some time away. Now you need to forward and give me all the work.
It's a me up there, work. You see me do my da. So me better work. When you walk out, la. When I care for my touch.
So froze. This is the Hawk Sports Network from SFMSports.net. This is the Hawk Sports Network from SFMSports.net. Hawk Sports Network from SFMSports.net. This is the 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 Hawk Sports Network from SFMSports.net. Our broadcast begins in 30 seconds. This is the Hawk Sports Network from SFMSports.net. Our broadcast begins in 10 seconds. University of Maryland Eastern Shore and SFMSports.net welcomes you to this presentation of UMES Hawks Basketball, brought to you by Pepsi, Courtyard by Marriott, Peninsula Regional Medical Center. UMES Basketball is also brought to you by Hampton Inns and Suites of Salisbury, Signed by Tomorrow, and Frugals. Now, UMES Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Maryland Eastern Shore basketball on the air tonight from the Heights Athletic Center in Princess Anne, and they will host the Florida A&M Rattlers here this evening. Welcome inside our pregame show, everyone. I'm Brendan Gulick alongside Dave Bird tonight. The men's basketball team at UMES had won four straight games in conference play, beating Bethune-Cookman, Coppin State, Howard, and Hampton, who at the time was the first place team in the league. And they started to look like things were really moving in the right direction. But since that win over Hampton, things have been twofold. One, the Hawks have lost their starting point guard in Ahmad Frost. He will miss the remainder of the season with a torn ACL and a torn meniscus in his right knee. And because of that, the Hawks have really struggled to find their identity on offense, even though they're still getting contributions from their upperclassmen. Four straight losses entering tonight's game against Norfolk State, Delaware State, Howard, and South Carolina State. Tonight's matchup against Florida A&M is one the Hawks should win. Florida A&M is the second worst team in college basketball, according to the RPI. They were ranked 350th out of 351. This is a game that the Hawks should win, but you know what they say, you got to play each game and take it one at a time. So, Dave, your thoughts going into tonight's game on really a critical contest for the Hawks?
Well, it is very critical, and we're home at the Heights Center, and we need to get a W tonight. On paper, as you said, it looks like if we play our best and they play their best, then we're going to win. But we still have not got it together since we lost our point guard in Ahmad Frost, and that is screwed up the rotation of players being played and the times being played and how things go. And we were just getting ourselves, we played pretty good during the beginning of the year, but we just started to get on a roll, as you said. And that's tough to find that replacement. Not that we don't have a replacement, but it just domino effect down the end of the bench of different people having to play different minutes, different people starting, different people playing, different type defenses, offenses. It just messes everything up. And unfortunately, we got to get over that. And if we don't, then it's going to be a tough road to hoe the next couple of games. But the opportunity is there right now to re-gear, restart tonight, and get a W.
Well, because of those problems at point guard, the Hawks have had to rely even more heavily on their upperclassmen, Dominique Elliott and Devin Martin. Elliott with 8 double-doubles, including 4 in his last 6 games. He is also coming off a career-high 23 points for the second time this year. He did that. Did it on Saturday against South Carolina State. The Hawks scored 34 points in the second half on Saturday. They got a 3-pointer from Mark Blackman. The other 31 were either from Elliott or from Devin Martin. They've got to have better balance today if they want to beat a Florida A&M team that is hungry to get out of the cellar of the conference. And keep in mind, before I let you elaborate, Florida A&M has nothing to lose. They are ineligible for the conference tournament, so they only have a couple games left in the regular season. And they would love to knock the Hawks off their high horse tonight.
Yeah, they're sitting at the bottom of the conference. They're also ineligible, like you say. But the bottom line is we got to get some contribution from other players to help the upperclassmen in order to win not only this game, but the rest of the season. If you notice, the games we have lost over the last four stretch have all been pretty close games. But not necessarily well played or doing great on one offense or defense, but the scores have been close. So that even shows you more how much we missed Frost in that rotation. He gave us a few, 8 points a game. He gave us a good defense. He gave us he got the ball to Martin and Elliott when he was supposed to, and that's the things we're missing right now. Hopefully somebody will step up tonight and get 10 or 15 points besides Dominic and Devin.
We'll take a timeout here on our pregame show, and when we come back, we'll give you the starting lineups as the Hawks get ready for their matchup tonight against Florida A&M. This is the Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
In a perfect world, every meal would be at Buffalo Wild Wings. Until then, we've got takeout. So now you can bring our hand-spun wings with 16 signature sauces and 5 seasonings with you. And the minute we figure out how to fit over 50 big screens into the trunk of your car, we'll let you know.
Takeout for any party, any size. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Your Salisbury B-Dubs is in the North Point Plaza on Route 13. Your Salisbury Buffalo Wild Wings, the only place for wings, beer, sports.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Brendan Gulick and Dave Bird with you. Let's give you the starting lineups for tonight's game as Florida A&M and Maryland Eastern Shore get ready with their final little warm-ups here on the floor. First for the host, Hawks at guard, making his third start of the season, a junior from Paris, France, Mark Seelan. At guard, a senior from Baltimore, Maryland, and one of the conference's leading scorers, Devin Martin. At forward, a junior from Philadelphia who has seen good minutes in his 17 starts this year, Shane Randall. At forward, a junior from Decatur, Georgia, Bakari Copeland. Copeland struggled with just 5 points in Saturday's loss. And finally, at forward, a senior from Savannah, Georgia, Dominique Elliott. Elliott coming off that career-high 23. So it's Seelan, Martin, Randall, Copeland, and Elliott tonight for Bobby Collins. Florida A&M will counterattack with these five. At forward, a 6'8", 235 junior from Norfolk, Trayvon Warren. At guard, a 6'3", 175-pound sophomore from St. Petersburg, Craig Bowman. At guard, a 5'9", 180-pound senior from Winston-Salem, North Carolina, Jaron Foster. At guard and their best player, a 6'6", 190-pound junior from Middleburg, Florida, and a transfer from Charleston Southern, Malcolm Bernard. And at guard, a 6'1", 175-pound freshman from Lithonia, Georgia, Justin Ravenel. Head coach of Florida A&M is Byron Samuels. He's in his second year. Head coach for the Hawks is Bobby Collins, also a second-year head coach. Dave Bird, that the big guy you got to keep your eye on tonight, Malcolm Bernard. Yeah. He's listed as a guard on the roster, plays more of the small forward role. He leads Florida A&M in literally everything. Points, rebounds, assists, steals, block shots, minutes played, you name it. Malcolm Bernard's our go-to guy.
Yeah, he's probably the most important guy to play on any team, because if he goes down, then Florida, the Rattlers are really, really hurting. And we're going to be interested to watch him and see how it puts him in ranking with the best players in the league. Our opinion, of course.
Florida A&M has lost 3 in a row. The Hawks have dropped 4 straight. Florida A&M has had 5 different 3-game losing streaks this year. They have never won back-to-back games. The Hawks obviously had a four-game winning streak about a couple weeks ago that was snapped with that loss to Norfolk State. That was their best winning streak of the year, and of course had a couple of tough losing stretches early in the season. So it's the Hawks who enter tonight's game with a 5-8 record in conference, 8-20 overall. The Rattlers are 7-18, 3-9 in the MEAC. We'll take our final timeout. When we come back, we'll get ready for the opening tip as the teams are about to be announced to those in attendance here tonight. It's Maryland Eastern Shore and Florida A&M next on the Hawks Sports Network.
Have you heard? Proactive is new and better than ever. Stay tuned for a million bottle giveaway, and you'll also receive free shipping. Do you have troubled skin, acne? Well, we have great news. With new Proactive, your acne can heal and you can prevent new breakouts from happening. Be one of the first to try it by giving us a call at 1-800-669-8096, because we're going to let a million people try new Proactive risk-free. Get two free gifts and also receive free shipping when you call right now. You heard it. Be one of the first to try new and better than ever Proactive, and you'll receive a 60-day risk-free trial of the new Proactive, two free extras, and free shipping when you call 1-800-669-8096. This is our best radio offer ever. Get your risk-free 60-day trial of new Proactive plus free shipping. That's right, free shipping. This offer won't last long. Call 1-800-669-8096. That's 1-800-669-8096.
Yesterday, I was embarrassed to have guests use my bathroom. Today, I can't wait to show it off. What a difference a day makes. It started with a simple phone call to Quick Bath Remodel Center. They connected us to a free in-home design consultation. We chose the style and color we wanted and then turned our old mildewy shower and tub into a luxurious shower we love. The remodel was quick, done in just one day. Here's the best part. Quick Bath Remodel Center referred us to factory-trained installers who handled everything for us. They custom-made our new walk-in shower to fit our existing bathroom space. Our home is not only more beautiful, it's more valuable, too. Imagine getting a beautiful new bathroom you'll love in just one day. We did it, and so can you, when you call Quick Bath Remodel Center today.
Call 800-870-3137. That's 800-870-3137. 800-870-3137. Call today, 800-870-3137.
How you doing? This is Devin Martin, senior guard from Maryland Eastern Shore, and you're now tuning in to Hawks Sports Network.
UMES and Florida A&M being introduced to the fans here inside the Hike Center tonight as we get ready for this evening's games. Again, if you missed the starting lineups when we gave them to you last segment, it's Trayvon Warren, Craig Bowman, Jaron Foster, Malcolm Bernard, and Justin Ravenel for Florida A&M. Mark Seeland, Devin Martin, Shane Randall, Bakari Copeland, and Dominique Elliott for the Hawks. Dave, is there a matchup between two guys tonight that you're most interested in watching?
No, I'm interested to see Bernard, number one, but I'm more interested to see how good Thomas Rivera plays coming off the bench, because I think he's going to be a key to the Hawks' success over the last several ball games. And he missed the entire last game, so we were down 2 point guards against South Carolina State, and it's going to be interesting to see how Thomas reacts. I can believe he can, if he plays well, the Hawks are going to do well.
Rivera missed that game on Saturday because of a suspension. Picked up a flagrant 2 foul in the game on Tuesday night, and so by rule had to miss the next game, which was this past weekend. By the way, we see some baseball players in the house. Want to congratulate them on their start to the year. 2-1 in their opening weekend against Fairleigh Dickinson. Nicely done. They won their first opening game of the year for the first time in like 22 years.
Long time. Yes.
Very well done. Congratulations to head coach John O'Neill. Hawks in white tops, white shorts. Florida A&M, black tops, black shorts with green and orange trim. Basically the same color scheme as the Miami Hurricanes, but black the predominant color. Our officials, Duke Edsel, Victor Montgomery, and Howard Davis. Warren and Elliott will jump center. Hawks will go left to right. Ball is in the air. It's controlled. Actually, I think it deflected off Florida A&M. Okay, they got that all straightened out. It'll be Hawks basketball.
Good.
It was tipped out of bounds, and they had to figure out who it touched. So the Hawks will have it. Sideline inbound, and now we're underway. Thanks for joining us here tonight. Mark Seelan into the floor on the right-hand side.
Man-man defense. Lot of rally.
And they are playing well outside the perimeter. Awfully close.
Yeah.
Martin on the left wing for the Hawks. Working against Bowman here early on. Finds Elliott. A fake and a drive into the paint. And he put it up, but he traveled before he shot the basketball.
There's a little traveling music out there. He came from a long way away.
You know, the last couple of games, we've seen the first play of the game run through Shane Randall. Today, Randall didn't get a touch inside the paint. First possession of the game for FAMU. Ravenel to the right side. It was deflected out off Martin. And the Hawks will play defense. Bernard to inbound right in front of Bobby Collins' bench. He finds Bowman in the corner. They work around the perimeter. Foster back to the top of the arc, and Bernard, who spins, fades from the free throw line, missed short. Martin grabs a rebound. The Hawks fly up the floor. Good feed into the low post. They want to get Elliott involved early, and Dominique cannot put it in from the right side. And then a foul call.
He fouled him from the behind.
Ah. You can't out there.
He missed a little bunny inside, and then Bernard got the rebound and took off. Dominic fouled from behind. That's not a good foul. Not a good foul. Bernard's got his wrist wrapped, too, taped up pretty substantially. I wonder if that's an old injury or a problem just jumped up.
Well, we were not given any information on that pregame, so not expecting that to play much of a role tonight. From the top of the arc, Bowman looking around. Passes left side, and we got an offensive foul in the key. I think it's on Warren. Trayvon Warren picks up his first. He's probably the best interior defender for Florida A&M.
Yeah.
I think you'll see him and Elliott going at it most of the night.
He's a big guy.
6'8", 235. Dominique's a little more long and lean. There's a blocking foul in the paint, and that one also goes on Warren.
Well,
he just picked up two fouls immediately, and that leaves Byron Samuels scratching his head.
Yeah, we may not see him very long. 1 minute and 25.
I say literally
a
minute and a half into the game, and Trayvon Warren's going to have basically probably sit the rest of the first half. He's played a minute and a half.
Now, the only way he comes off now is if this game started getting out of hand.
Makari Copeland pops the first free throw in. So it brings Francois Lewis, who actually won the Player of the Week award as a rookie. I believe it was the first or second week of the season.
He's a
6'9", 220 from Orlando. A lot of backcourt pressure from the Hawks. FAMU breaks it on the right wing. Foster dribbles in the forecourt, gives to Bernard, who goes right toward Randall and lost the ball. Picked up by Copeland. Hawks lead it 2-0. Left corner, Elliott has it. Faked, gave to Randall inside. Shane had it stripped away. That was probably a good thing. Shane was a little off balance. Devin Martin explodes to the right elbow, pulls up and knocks down a jump shot.
Stop and pop at the right elbow, about 15 feet.
2 minutes gone by. Hawks lead it with a couple of early baskets. And Shane Randall is called for a very touch. No, Devin Martin is called for the foul. Devin can't believe it. Well, if anybody fouled him, it was Randall. But the foul goes on Devin Martin. Wow. So Martin and Elliott both pick up fouls in the first 2 minutes of the game.
And Bowman coming up limping for the Rattlers.
Yeah, he started to slow up a little bit when he went into that spin move. Screen is set for by Lewis. They work to the left side now. Bowman looking around, dribbling right-handed, left-handed three-point shot with Martin in his grill, and he buries it.
Well, he made a three, but he's still limping going back down the floor.
UMES, a one-point lead, 2.5 minutes into the game. Copeland between the circles, splits two defenders. Great move. No look pass to Martin underneath, who fakes twice, put it up, and it was blocked. That was great ball rotation, but they couldn't finish at the rim. Bernard in transition with a pass into the right-hand corner. A couple of fakes from his teammate, freshman guard Justin Ravenel. And he stops forcing the issue. They go out to the left wing where Bowman kicks and drives, and a turnover right side. Martin comes away with a 3-on-2. Here's Seelan. In rhythm three, right wing, and he missed it long. Randall the rebound. So offensive life.
Wide open there. And he had to knock that down.
Elliott in the right corner. Step inside the arc. Puts up a jump shot. It floats too long. Not a good start for the Hawks. They lead, though, 4-3. On the right wing, the Foster comes into the floor. Finds Bernard, who fakes and drives and lays it in with a left hand. 5-4, Florida A&M. It will bring Ryan Andino and Thomas Rivera off the bench. Elliott gives to Martin on the right side of the floor. Devins dribbles between two defenders into the middle of the paint, floats it in. Fancy little move from Devin Martin.
Split the defenders.
6-5, each team with a couple early fouls. We're 4 minutes in. On the right wing, backing his way, Bowman finds Lewis. Deep three, right side, clanks off the back of the cylinder.
Lewis, a 6'9", freshman, shooting the deep three.
Seelan wants to go all the way to the rim, gave it underneath to Copeland. Bakari forced it up, and he got hit. Who is the foul called on is the question.
I think it's 21.
No, they're going to hit Lewis. Francois Lewis picks up his first, team third.
Wow.
Timeout on the floor with 15:51 left in the opening half. The Hawks lead it 6-5. This is the Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
The Courtyard by Marriott on Route 13 in Salisbury offers comfortable rooms and meeting spaces, as well as always superior customer service in a great location near the mall. Call 410-742-4405 and ask for details about their special UMES athletics rate. The Courtyard by Marriott in Salisbury, an official hotel of UMES Athletics and a proud sponsor of Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
A lot of defense in the early part of the game. The Hawks lead it 6-5. We are 4 minutes in. UMES has forced three Florida A&M turnovers so far. I think it's because the Hawks have come out with better defensive energy, Dave, but on the offensive side, UMES has not been able to finish at the rim. They've hit a couple of layups, but 2 of 6 shooting, and they missed a wide-open three-point shot.
Just from looking at both teams to begin with, we have a definite size advantage and bulk advantage that we could take advantage of. How about that?
An advantage we can take advantage of.
How about that?
That's right. Thank
you. You haven't heard that before, have you?
Thank you, Captain Obvious.
Yeah.
Copeland hit the first free throw. Second one, good as well. So he's 4-for-4 to start the night from the free throw line. And the Hawks have an 8-5 lead.
And a full-quarter little pressure here by the Hawks. With Copeland up front.
Andino and Rivera into the game first time. Here's a drive at the basket. Left wing, Bowman lays it in. 8-7. Bowman gets another basket. He hit a three. Now he's got a two, so give him 5 in the game.
That was a tough shot.
Martin, right wing for the Hawks, goes up top to Thomas Rivera. A pass to Ryan Andino, who last year led the conference in three-point shooting. This year is not even among the league leaders. Martin, just right of center, 5 to let it fly. Decides to drive, kicks to Rivera. Three ball deflected in the right corner. Pulled in for by Florida A&M. It was tipped by K.J. Johnson and a foul up the floor the other way. K.J. spells his name K-apostrophe-J-A. K.J. Johnson.
One thing I noticed also is that the Rattlers have two left-handed players that are predominant. They go to the left side, both in Bernard and Bauman.
So Bernard, the first free throw, no good. Popped away to the right side. He did not connect.
Yeah. Rattler's not a very good three-throw shooting team, but only 58% for the year.
No, and when you do that as a team, that really hurts.
Yes.
It's manageable, I guess, if you've got a couple guys that are struggling. But when you're as a group, as Bernard misses the second one too, when you're doing that as a group, it's tough to win games. Martin, a left wing transition three, got a good look, but it popped out. By the way, Isaac Taylor in the game for Dominique Elliott and the Hawks in the right corner. Nicholas Severato threw it away underneath. Here's Rivera streaking up the floor. Finds Andino right corner. And Andino looking to the top of the arc. Finds Rivera once more. Martin left side three. Hit it. Devin Martin 7 points here in the early going. Hawks lead it 11-7.
And Devin's going to make that wide open three.
Dribbling in the forecourt along the left wing. Johnson working against Rivera. Great ball handling skills. Blows by him. Jump stops in the paint. A poor pass right at the foot of Lewis. And it goes out of bounds. Everything else was great. Yeah. Johnson holds his arm in the air and apologizes for it. Takes responsibility.
Yeah, those 6'9", 6'10 guys don't like to bend down and catch balls around their ankles. It's a tough pass. The Rattlers in a 2-3 matchup zone.
Bernard just checked out of the game. Francois Lewis, the big man in the middle at 6'9", 220. Martin in the left wing draws a lot of attention outside the rainbow. Devin's got the ball, fake from three, where he just hit a moment ago. Finds Rivera top of the arc, and Thomas traveled. Thomas disagrees with the whistle, but I think he picked up his pivot foot.
Martin seems to be feeling it tonight. I would get the ball in his hands at every opportunity.
Well, Devin's only got two home games left in his college career, and he's been awfully focused throughout the course of the week. I know he doesn't want to waste any opportunities here playing at home. Jericho Peck waits to check in for UMES. Johnson dribbles at midcourt, goes right down Broadway, finds an open Bowman, left wing three again.
Same spot as the first three for Bowman.
Bowman's got eight, Bernard's got two. It's 11-10, UMES by one. Martin in the forecourt at the 13:30 mark of the first half. Rivera dribbles top of the key, looks into the high part of the post. Taylor couldn't handle the pass, and then I think he committed a foul.
Yeah,
sure did. Isaac Taylor commits his first personal, team fourth, and Copeland is replaced. Now Thomas Rivera leaves as well. Dante Caldwell and Derek Opek both on the floor for the first time. Johnson will run the point. He directs traffic as Severato goes into the right corner. Johnson passes left side. Bowman with a strong move into the paint. Jump pass deflected right back to him. Underneath, and Taylor fouls him again.
Taylor
with two fouls in about 10 seconds.
These fouls seem to be react fouls, but then you do something and make a mistake, like a missed drop pass or a missed bucket, and then you react on doing that by fouling. We've done that about three times this game already.
It's a lack of focus.
That's a possibility.
First free throw up and in from Craig Bowman. Give him a nine. A layup, a couple of threes, and now a free throw. Bowman one more. That one did not fall through for him. Bowman on the year averaging nine a game. Actually, just under nine a game.
And he's got that.
And I think he's the one that gets hit for the foul in the backcourt. Sure did. His first, team fourth. He got in the way coming up the floor. I think he was asking for a charge. Did not come. So the hot shooting Bowman has a seat. Justin Ravenel and K.J. Johnson, the two guards. Malcolm Bernard came back on the floor. Isaac Taylor in the low post, forced it up, missed it. Caldwell grabbed the loose ball. Here's Andino, right wing. Can't hit the three.
Oh,
it did go in.
Back,
hit the back of the rim, popped straight up, hit the backboard and fell through.
We'll take it.
14-11. Left corner, Severato draws a double, lobs to the top of the floor. Bravenell changes the other side. Bernard back to the left side now, and Johnson. A pass toward the left corner. Severato fakes and drives and throws it away. Peck two on two. He just races up the floor, and he gets bumped by Bernard. Derek Opeck looked like he was running the 100-meter dash.
And he was by everybody. That's why he got the foul.
Holy smokes. How about that? I haven't seen Derrico run full sprint like that all year on offense. You know he's athletic, but that was impressive. Andino.
A good foul.
I guess we got a foul on the floor away from the shot.
35.
It's the third foul on Isaac Taylor, and we've only played 7.5 minutes. Elliott to the scorer's table. Taylor to the bench. Taylor was supposed to give him some minutes because Elliott picked up an early foul, and instead it's Isaac that grabs three. So the depth will be tested for the Hawks tonight from Florida A&M. I know they're down three, but they're not in a bad position. Hawks go to a zone defense with a small group out there.
Peck at the top of it. It's a 1-2-2 with Peck on the basketball.
Pass to the right side. Butler back to Johnson, who fakes and tries to drive. Back to Bernard. Three ball right side. Buries it. Four threes in the early going for Florida A&M. Only one other basket. Bernard gets into the scoring column from distance. He's got five, and Bowman's got nine.
They're only a 30% three-point shooting team, too. So.
Martin passes to Caldwell. Wide open triple. He can't answer. Peck rips away the offensive rebound, but when he pulled it in, his foot was on the baseline. That was a great move by Derrico to grab the ball when it looked for certain like Florida A&M controlled it. Timeout on the floor. We are tied at 14, and right now the Rattlers are giving the Hawks all they can handle. 11:37 left in the opening half. This is the Hawk Sports Network through SFMSports.net.
Each week, go inside the athletics program at the University of Maryland Eastern Shore with Hawks Talk.
I'm Brendan Gulick, radio voice of the Hawks, and we're joined today by head coach Bobby Collins.
Hear from UMES coaches.
The one thing that we did, we played hard.
Student athletes.
Being a student athlete, obviously, student is first.
We're happy to do it in front of what is a really nice crowd here on Wednesday night at Buffalo Wild Wings on Route 13 in Salisbury. We'll be here from 7 to 8.
It's Hawks Talk from SFMSports.net on Fox Sports 960.
The Hampton Inn and Suites Fruitland Salisbury South is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you includes a clean, comfortable hotel room, located only 7.5 miles from the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. Also conveniently located within walking distance of 5 different restaurants, plus a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to the campus. Hampton Inn and Suites, an official hotel of UMES Athletics.
Hey Hawks fans, this is Derek Opeck, senior guard. Thanks for listening to Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball. This is Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
Right time.
Let's pause 10 seconds for a station identification. You're listening to Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball tonight on the Hawks Sports Network. Alongside Dave Burt, I'm Brendan Gulick. Maryland Eastern Shore 14, Florida A&M 14, with 11:37 left in the opening half. Second to last regular season home game, third to last regular season game for UMES. Florida A&M ineligible for the conference tournament, so they have nothing to lose, even though they're the last place team in the MEAC right now. Hawks with Blackman, Elliott, Caldwell, Andino, and Peck out there. Mark Blackman's first action of the game. Hawks on defense off to our left as Bernard goes right through the middle of the paint, missed the layup. He was too far underneath the basket, couldn't get a good look off, and one of his teammates committed a foul while trying to jockey for the rebound. Goes on Nicholas Severato.
And Bernard tried to shoot that with the right hand that's taped up that time when he got near the bucket.
Got a whole lot of whistles here early in the game. Yeah. 12 fouls
already
combined, each team with 6 in the first almost 9 minutes. Andino from the top of the arc. We've had a lot of threes already, too. Andino lobs underneath to Elliott, who puts it up and drew another foul. Dominique Elliott goes right into the meat of that Rattlers defense.
I don't think the Rattlers can handle the Hawks if they go down inside with that basketball. Let's make me see who can survive the foul fest later on in this basketball game, especially late in the second half, if it stays close.
Isaiah Omoregi picks up the foul. And Elliott's free throw does not go.
That was way down in there.
Coach Collins just now taking off the tie. And that's about 9 minutes later than he took it off on Saturday. Elliott up. And he badly missed that one. I don't even know if that hit the rim. Fam, you up the floor quickly. Oh, boy. Bowman almost put up a trail three. Instead, Bernard top of the arc back to Bowman, who bobbled it before he could shoot it. Bernard bounces underneath. Omoregi turns and spins and puts it over way over the rim. Peck the rebound. That was not a good look.
Wow. He had a good look. It was just not a good shot.
Tied at 14. Andino's entry pass poked away. Coming up the floor. Into the left corner, Blackman guards him tightly. To the right corner now, K.J. Johnson feeds the post, and a Hawk is there. It's Peck taking it away. He goes all the way, coast to coast, and is fouled on the layup. Derrick O'Peck zigzagging his way up the floor, through the Rattlers, and to the rim. And he's got two free throws coming in a tie game.
Yeah, Peck is full speed ahead and almost unstoppable, unless you foul him.
First foul on Justin Ravenel, team eighth. Trayvon Warren, the only one with two fouls. Peck's free throw is good. 15-14 Hawks as Devin Martin returns for Ryan Andino. Andino hit a three ball.
Both teams using their entire bench.
Bowman's the leading scorer right now with 9 points in the game. Martin's got seven to lead the Hawks. Jericho's second free throw counts as well. He's got a couple. Hawks lead at 16-14. We are just in front of the midway point of the first half. Florida A&M in a makeup game here at home. The game was originally scheduled for January 25th, but postponed due to inclement winter weather. Bowman up top, lobs toward the right corner where Bernard immediately gives it away. Here's Foster in the lane to an open left wing three. No good over the top of the rim from Ravenel. Elliott the rebound. That's his second. Martin in transition got a pass from Peck and went right into the middle of the maroon paint and got hit.
It seems like every time we go inside, there's a foul.
Jaron Foster picks up his first, the senior from Winston-Salem. 16-14 UMES and Devin Martin to the stripe. The Hawks are definitely using their senior class with Martin and Elliott kind of pacing things, but love the energy from Derrick O'Peck here early in the game. Right now, Peck is kind of the point guard on the floor without Rivera or Seelan out there.
Also, both teams are now
18-14. Yeah, both teams shooting it well. In fact, I don't think either team has missed. No, I beg your pardon. Elliott missed them both. Other than that, we've only seen makes from the free throw line from both teams. Bowman taps his head from the left wing. Passes to the right side to Foster. Back to Bowman. Up top three. That one popped away. Elliott took the rebound away from Caldwell, his third rebound. Martin pushes it. Wants to go right to the rim. Finds Peck cutting from the corner, and Devin is called for an offensive foul. He just picked up his second.
Devin to stop and pop and shoot that, you know, 15-foot jump shot that he can shoot so well right now. It's like everybody wants to be a racehorse today and fly down the court.
We've seen 16 fouls in the first half. 9 on the Rattlers, 7 on the Hawks. UMES with active feet defensively. They're all jumping around in place. Now FAMU into the forecourt, top of the arc. Bowman wants to feed it into the post where Mario Karaliev has just checked in, the senior from Bulgaria. Instead, a left wing shot up and in.
A little left hand hook.
Yep. Karaliev gets his first. 18-16. Elliott fakes on the baseline. Karaliev denies him the drive. And instead, Elliott forced his way, tiptoeing the baseline, and Karaliev fouled him.
There's no way he can handle Elliott going in there. He's just got to, if he backs off, then Dom could shoot that little jump shot. If he goes and gets him, Dominic should be able to go right by.
First down, Mario. Team 10th with 8:52 left in the first half. Elliott from the free throw line has to be good today because he can get there a lot. And the first one is off the mark. He's 0 for his first three. He hit 3 of 4 against South Carolina State on Saturday. But in this losing streak, things have gone awry for him. 5 of 8 against Norfolk State, 1 of 4 from the line against Dell State, and against Howard, after hitting his first two, he then went 2 for 8 after that, finished 4 of 10 from the free throw line that game. Finally hits one there. It is 19-16. 8:45 left in the first half. Hawks by 3. They have never trailed in this game, but they've been tied a couple of times. On the right wing, Foster has the ball, right-handed waist-side dribble. Goes to the right elbow, passes the ball off to Bowman. He wants to circle all the way to the hoop, spun it off the window, did not go. Rebound out of bounds, back to the Hawks.
Both teams are kind of wild going through the basket.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of athleticism, but not a lot of it's been controlled.
Yeah, that's what I mean. They're wild going through the basket. Playing hard and going hard.
Copeland raises from the left corner with his foot on the three-point line and missed it. Blackman tipped the rebound out of bounds. So it goes back to Florida A&M. UMES in the middle of a four-game slide. Their biggest win of the year was their last win at home against Hampton, who at the time was the conference leader. And at the current moment, they still are a half game up on South Carolina State. Bowman fakes and drives on Peck. Blocked at the rim. Copeland with one hand throws it sky high. Pulled in by Bernard at the free throw line. And out of control, he goes through the lane and puts it in. Unbelievable.
Yep. Contact everywhere on that play. Like you said, a huge amount of athleticism on the floor tonight, but everybody playing hard, going hard to the basket, but not a whole lot of results.
Timeout on the floor with 7:56 left in the first half. Maryland Eastern Shore leads it 19-18. Back in a moment, this is the Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
My doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of 7 entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of 7 sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you gonna go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Meet Heather. She's 5'8", attractive and single. Enjoys time with friends and Fells Point. And by midnight, she's going to be killed by a drunk driver. Are you going to kill Heather?
If you drink and drive, lives are at risk. That's why Maryland police are stopping and arresting drunk drivers with checkpoints and intense patrols. They'll see you before you see them.
Unit 850 stopping a suspected DUI.
Checkpoint Strike Force is back. Drive sober or get pulled over.
Well, we haven't seen a very clean first half. Maryland Eastern Shore leads 19-18 with just under 8 minutes left in the first half. The teams have combined for 13 turnovers in the first 12 minutes, and we've also seen a total, if you can believe it, of 18 fouls already. This game is starting to look like what we saw last Tuesday at Howard, when Howard and UMES combined for 57 fouls. I really hope we don't get there. Craig Bowman's had a nice day. 9 points. He and Devin Martin each with 9 to lead all scorers. Malcolm Bernard has 7. Florida A&M hit their first 3 triples, missed their next 3. Bernard from the free throw line knocks it in. He's 1 of 3 from the line. We are tied at 19. Actually, come to think of it, Florida A&M did have a lead by 1 point early in the game, but that was it. And it only lasted 15 seconds. Copeland passes to Peck in the right corner. They're out there with Blackman, Andino, and Elliott. And Peck, Blackman, and Andino are the 3 guards. No Martin, no Rivera, no Seelan. So who's going to run the point? We'll find out. Elliott from the left corner, two to shoot. Andino, deep three, and he knocked it in. Ryan Andino pounds his chest as he runs back up the floor. 22-19 UMES. Andino with his second three of the game.
And we'll take Andino. Opportunity to get hot.
Bowman from the keyhole. It was tipped above the rim, I believe. I think that's offensive goaltending. Let's make sure. It is offensive interference, so Hawks get it back. Bernard went up there to try to tip it in. Rivera back in there for Blackman. Hawks by three, 7:07 to play first half. Rivera with neon yellow-colored compression shorts on that are popping out underneath those white shorts when he's running, and the shorts are whisking in the breeze. Elliott draws a double team, finds Rivera wide open for three. It doesn't go, and Peck could not get the putback dunk. A foul is called underneath. I think it's Tondarico.
It's on Peck. He fouled Bernard. Bernard had both hands on the ball going up. A good rebound by Bernard. Good hustle by Peck, but kind of a wasted foul.
His first team ninth, and it's a 1-1 for Florida A&M. UMES with a three-point lead, 6:51 left in the first half. Florida A&M, for a while, along with Delaware State, were the two worst teams in the conference. Tip your hat to Delaware State, the team that will come here next Saturday. They beat Norfolk State this past Saturday, a couple days ago.
They seem to be improving just a little bit. Might be somebody to watch headed into the MEAC tournament.
Severato replaces Foster on the floor. Both free throws go. It's 22-21 as Caldwell is back on the floor for Bakari Copeland. Inbound comes Rivera up the left side of the floor, looking around. Finds Andino, transition left corner three. Too strong, and a foul as everybody went jumping for the ball.
Number 11.
It's going to send Elliott to the line.
That would be Bernard.
Bernard picks up his second. Only Bernard and Warren have more than one foul. And Byron Samuels is as hot as you can be without picking up a technical foul. So Elliott with two free throws. The Hawks are in the double bonus. Dominique cannot hit. My goodness. So Bernard picks up his second, and that's going to play a role here for Florida A&M. I think the Hawks will be wise to go at him as Elliott airballed the next free throw. What is going on with Dominique? At some point, you wonder if it just starts to get in his head a little bit.
It's got to be mental because that wasn't even close.
22-21. He missed them both. Elliott from the line tonight is 1-for-6. Bernard circles from the left to the right side of the floor. Blocked from behind by Caldwell. He got the ball clean, but he also hit him on the shoulder. It was a good call. Caldwell did his best there to recover after he got beat off the dribble. Bernard just elusive as he runs through the paint like that.
The bottom line is both teams are not playing very good perimeter defense. That means everybody's getting to the rack anytime they want, and every time they get in there, guess what?
Hawks lead.
Fouled.
Yeah. Hawks lead at 22-21 and now 22-22 after the free throw.
Whoever decides to buckle down and play a little defense and do not let the penetration, could have a good chance to win this basketball game.
Malcolm Bernard hits them both. The leader of the Rattlers checks out of the game. KJ Johnson comes back in.
He could be sitting down for the last 6 minutes. That's a big chunk of time.
Rivera off the inbound. Works with Peck and Caldwell in the backcourt. Dante poorly dribbled the ball near midcourt. Florida A&M dives on it and calls a timeout. 6:23 left in the opening half. This will be just a 30-second timeout for the Rattlers. Florida A&M is just playing harder right
they're
now.
They're playing hard, like I said. I think they smell a W because they got an opportunity here. They're playing just a little bit harder than the Hawks.
The other side of the coin is they don't have anything to lose. If you're not eligible for the conference tournament and you're not eligible for any other postseason tournament, you just go out and you play your best in every game and let it ride out.
That's right.
They have an unfortunate pattern, if you're a Hawks fan, of late, having won a game, then lost three. Win a game, lose three. Win a game, lose three. They've done that four times in a row. Problem is, they've lost three entering tonight.
That's not a good sign.
So Bowman and Johnson will work as the guards. Bowman, who is left-handed, goes to the left wing against the 1-3-1 zone. Johnson back to the right side, bounces underneath, and it was poor to Carolee out of bounds.
Again, they're throwing the ball to the feet of some of their offensive players, especially a big guy.
Hawks with their first deficit since basically the opening minute of the game. Great backcourt pressure, but Rivera and the Hawks get through it. Thomas all the way to the rim. Found Elliott and one. Thomas went all the way under the hoop, and when it looked like he was going up to try to lay the ball up, he behind the defender's back passed it to Elliott. First personal foul. Second personal foul called for Florida A&M's Craig Bowman.
And Bernard's back in the game, so that didn't last very long. And Bernard has two fouls. This is a risky move.
Caldwell, Elliott, Randall, Rivera, and Andino now out there for the Hawks. Dominique takes his time, and the free throw's good. He's hit two of seven, 25-23. Yeah, that one he shot with some confidence.
Yeah, looked good. Great rotation. Zone by the Hawks.
Elliott
one,
has
2-2.
Yep, Elliott's got 4 points. Here in the first half. Bernard on the right wing. He's got 12 and 4 to lead Florida A&M. Bowman up top, back to Bernard. Dribbling on the right wing, calling for a screen. Used it. Dribble to the left. High key. Backdoor pass. Turned into an easy layup from Nicholas Severato on the weak side. 25 all. 5.5 minutes left here in the opening frame. Caldwell lobs to the low right block extended. Elliott, diagonal pass, top side of the floor. Rivera bounces low left key. Randall turns around, banks it high off the glass. No, and a hard foul on Elliott. He didn't mean to. It was maybe more a hard fall than a hard foul. But nonetheless, Dominique picks up his second. 5:18 left in the first half. Derek Opek's going to come off the bench.
Most likely, Dominique. To sit the last 5:18, as you said, of this first half.
Martin's got two, Elliott's got two, Isaac Taylor with three fouls. Both teams in the double bonus, and they have been for a fortnight. First free throw did not go for Nicholas Severato. Elliott out, Peck back in. Some nervous fans here inside the Heights Center.
Yeah.
The team had won five in a row at home, but they've lost their last two. Up and good, and it's a lead for Florida A&M. Free throws are split. Rivera dribbles from the right wing back to the middle of the floor. On to double team. Pass to the left corner. Randall denied driving a baseline. Shane picks up his dribble. He's trapped, so he throws up top to Caldwell. Hands the ball to Rivera. 5 minutes to play, opening half. Caldwell, catch and shoot three. No good, left wing. Bernard the rebound. He's got eyes up the floor as he dribbles around two defenders. Passes to the right corner, and Bowman is fouled as he went trying to drive him into baseline.
Florida A&M just has a little more hop in their step, especially on the defensive end. They're gambling. They're trapping people. They're going after people on the defensive end.
Shane Randall commits his first. Florida A&M going to shoot their 12th and 13th free throws in the first half. The Hawks have hit 10 of 15. First one from FAMU missed. They are now 7 of 12. Hawks are hitting 32%. Florida A&M 44% from the floor. The Hawks have turned it over eight times, and UMES is plus four on the glass. Second free throw good from Bowman, 27-25. Blackman back in the ballgame for Dante Caldwell. Coach Collins really likes Mark Blackman's energy, and as a junior, he and Randall are the two most veteran players on the team. Andino throws a full-court pass to Peck. It deflects off Derrico, out of bounds. Good look, but just a little too much on it. Ninth giveaway for the Hawks.
Exactly.
4:40 and counting here in the opening half. Both these two teams playing in a late season, regular season contest. Only time they'll meet all year. Johnson fires back to the top of the arc. Bernard working on Rivera toward the right elbow. Passes left corner. Bowman three. Yes. It is the Bernard and Bowman show here today.
The B&B, the two left-handers.
30-25, Florida A&M. They're shooting the ball a lot better than the Hawks are so far. Bernard's got 12, Bowman's got 10 of the team's 30. Randall finds Andino in the right corner, under 4 minutes to play in the first half. Now Rivera top of the arc with gray sneakers and gold shoelaces. And Bernard walked right into Rivera. That has ticked off the coaching staff. Not a good foul.
His third foul.
Well, that's why they're angry. It was a stupid foul by Bernard, and he knows it. Timeout on the floor, 3:53 left in the first half. Hawks down a handful, 30-25. Maryland Eastern Shore basketball continues after this timeout here on the Hawks Sports Network.
Delmarva Power has two new ways for customers to save money and energy this summer.
There is always something on in our house.
Washer, dryer, and in the summertime, the air conditioner.
The Peak Energy Savings Credit is a hands-on way for all customers to save money and energy. When a peak savings day happens, make simple changes like waiting a few hours before doing laundry, using a barbecue grill, and more to earn bill credits. We'll even notify you the night before a peak savings day so you'll be ready to save.
I'm always looking for ways to save.
Energy Wise Rewards is the automatic way for customers to save money and energy.
Automatic works for me.
On a peak savings day, your central air conditioner or your heat pump will be automatically cycled off and on for short periods. And the difference in temperature is just a few degrees, so you can stay comfortable. So sign up and get started saving today.
We know that people want to save.
Visit delmarva.com/peak to learn more.
Hey, this is CM Ford, Dominic Elliott, and you are now listening to Hawk Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Well, UMES trying to get things squared away here offensively. They've missed their last couple shots from the floor, along with two turnovers, and they trail 30-25 and are under four media timeout in our first half. Joined us late, I'm Brendan Gulick, Dave Bird alongside. This will be the last time Dave's with us in the regular season. He probably won't be here on Saturday. Said he's got a conflict, so we'll look forward to having you down in Norfolk for the MEAC tournament.
I'm looking forward to the scope in Norfolk.
Are you coming up to Morgan State? That's the real question for the regular season finale.
I'll be in the middle
Thursday night.
I'll be in the middle of high school playoffs. That could be, if I'm lucky enough, both of my teams will be seeded number one tomorrow, and I could have six games in a row at Pocomoke High School.
Rivera up and missed the second after hitting the first. Best of luck to Pocomoke High, no doubt.
Thank you.
Hawks by four, 3:43 and counting here in the first half. Florida A&M on the road, playing well enough right now. Bowman dribbles around the perimeter, passes through the hands of his teammate Ravenel in the corner. Oh, man. He just took his eyes off the ball and gave it away.
The Hawks will pick up some defensive intensity, we hope.
Eighth giveaway by Florida A&M. 3:28 and counting. Thomas Rivera at midcourt looking around. Needs something. Passes to Derek Opeck. Now some offensive movement. Peck to the free throw line. Passes to Blackman, 10 to shoot. Marcos to work. Pulls up and cannot hit. Great handles, but he didn't hit the shot. Johnson running. Stopped in the middle of paint. Threw it behind his back to Lewis, who couldn't handle it. Here's Blackman the other way for the Hawks. Rivera finds Peck. Alley-oop layup. Nice job. 30-28. Under 3 minutes to play in the first half.
And the Hawks need to make up this time while Rattler's best player is sitting on the bench.
Derek Opeck got over-aggressive trying to trap Johnson across midcourt. His second.
you would think the guys in stripes are calling a lot of fouls, but actually, they're fouls.
I was just going to say, it's not a pretty overly officiated game. It's just been a bad game.
They're just hacking each other.
But 25 fouls in the first half.
And missing free throw.
Johnson misfires. The Rattlers are 8 of 14 from the line as both Lewis and Ravenel check out. Second one on its way, and it's good. Isaiah Omoreji checks back in. He'll be the big guy in the middle. Nicholas Severato back on the floor as well with Johnson, Jaron Foster, and Craig Bowman. 2:33 left in the first half. Hawks down 3. UMES has hit 11 of 17 free throws. Skip pass from right to left wing. Blackman couldn't do anything. Here's Andino, top of the arc. I don't know why he thought that was a good look. He was about 45 feet from the basket. 31-28. That's only a slight exaggeration.
Not much.
On the right side, dribbling back to the top of the arc. Severato gives way. Bowman controls. Craig passes right side. This is Omoreji. Omoreji dribbling around. 2 minutes to play, 7 to shoot. Into the right corner. Bowman has to do something. Threw it away to the left side. Too many passes that time from the Rattlers. Hawks running. Here's Peck. Finished underneath. Blackman to Rivera to Peck. Great ball work. 31-30. Hawks down 1. Final 1:39 of the half. Severato between the circles gives to Bowman. He weaves to the right side and a travel. 9th turnover from Florida. Check that, 10th turnover by Florida A&M.
If you notice, the Hawks are picking up the intensity, and they need to. And it's a smart move because the Rattlers' best players on the bench, now's the time to make your move.
Jonathan Spicer makes his first appearance tonight. And a second substitution brings Francois Lewis into the game. He'll defend Shane Randall. Final 90 seconds of the first half. Hawks down 31-30. Shooting in the basket off to our right. We are opposite the teams sitting courtside. Caldwell, Randall, and Blackman weave around. It's Caldwell on the right wing who wants Rivera's help. He'll pass up top to Thomas. Well outside the three-point line. Thomas makes a move. Drives to the right side of the key. Kicks to Blackman in the corner. Right wing Andino. Three ball. Yes! And a fist pump. Andino's got his third triple of the first half. 9 points for Andino. Hawks lead by 2. Under a minute to play as Bowman sidesteps into traffic and a foul. And it's on Shane Randall, his second. The crowd is getting restless with all of the whistles, but again, that was definitely a foul.
Yeah. They had to call something. They almost knocked it. And then they got poor guy down in the lane.
26 fouls in the first half. Craig Bowman's going to shoot a couple with 54 seconds left. And he missed the front end. 8 of 14 from the free throw line in this first half. Check that. You know what? Our live stats haven't updated in a bit.
Yeah, that's a little bit more. I'm just trying to.
We'll see if we can get you some updated numbers, but they're not good, I'll tell you that. Bowman's up and good again. UMES with under a minute to play. In the forecourt, Rivera holds offensively. The Hawks still have a timeout. And finally, called for 42.4 on the clock.
18 seconds on the shot clock. Time, plenty of time to get a good shot and play good defense to get into the halftime break.
And even though Coach Collins was yelling for a timeout, part of the new rules this year, those officials cannot acknowledge that. They have to wait for a player to call the timeout. So it took a minute for that to actually transpire. See if we can have some updated numbers here. Trying to get them for you, folks.
I got it.
Okay, how about the free throws?
Team stats. 10 for 17 are the Rattlers.
That's not ideal.
That's not ideal. The Hawks for 11 for 17. So that's why the games are close.
Not ideal either. All right. Hawks by one, 33-32. And Dino inbounds sideline right in front of Florida A&M's bench. They had a ball that was deflected out. Yes, it stays with the Hawks. And Dino looking around, lobs into the backcourt. Rivera pulls it in. Johnson backs away from him. 15 to shoot. 35 seconds now in the first half. Randall, right side of the floor. Fakes, wants to drive, behind the back dribble. Good athletic move in the paint. And a foul called against Francois Lewis, who might have hit him, Dave, but I don't know if he could have played much better defense than he did.
He played pretty good defense. The problem is our arm came down a little bit, and he got called for the foul.
Now, Lewis is frustrated. He just got called for a second. I don't blame him. I don't know how... I don't know, as an official, what you would tell him to do differently. I mean, you've got to be able to try to defend as well.
Yeah.
Randall probably just put on a dribbling exhibition more than he has all year. He doesn't usually get an ISO play.
That's
he
right.
Hits the first free throw, and Seelan checks back in. Randall's second free throw good as well. 35-32 Hawks. Now on the floor for UMES. Rivera, Seelan, Peck, Randall, and Blackman. It's a small group with his shot clock turned off. Ravenel will check back in as well. Sits down.
28 seconds left in the half.
Johnson runs the point. He's out there with Foster, Lewis, the aforementioned Craig Bowman, and Ravenel. They could tie it with a three-pointer. They will probably shoot the last bucket of the half. Rattlers in the forecourt, 10 seconds to play. Left wing, Foster looking around outside the arc. Spins away from Rivera, sidesteps a defender. Passes underneath, and a foul as Lewis threw it up. 3.6 left in the first half. I'd have driven inside, too.
Yeah, because it was most likely going to be fouled sometime. And that's what we bet.
Derek Opeck just picked up his third. Well, the only good news right now in terms of fouls for the Hawks is that Martin and Elliott have sat for a while.
A long time.
And they both are stuck on two. First free throw, up and good from Lewis. There's Caldwell back in, and Andino back as well. Let's see who stays on. Andino, Rivera, Randall, Blackman, Caldwell. Lewis with a second free throw coming. It's 35-33. Shot is up. No good. Caldwell the rebound. Comes up the right sideline. Chucks it up from half court. Looks pretty decent, but hits the top of the window. And that's it. So Maryland Eastern Shore edges out Florida A&M in the first half. 35-33 in a first half that saw 28 total fouls. Check that, 29 fouls. 15 on the Hawks, 14 on the Rattlers. We had 19 first half turnovers. UMES allowed Florida A&M to shoot 47%. We'll go over the numbers when we come back on our Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. That's next. Hawks by two at the break on the Hawks Sports Network.
Yesterday, I was embarrassed to have guests use my bathroom. Today, I can't wait to show it off. What a difference a day makes. It started with a simple phone call to Quick Bath Remodel Center. They connected us to a free in-home design consultation. We chose the style and color we wanted and then turned our old mildewy shower and tub into a luxurious shower we love. The remodel was quick, done in just one day. Here's the best part. Quick Bath Remodel Center referred us to factory-trained installers who handled everything for us. They custom-made our new walk-in shower to fit our existing bathroom space. Our home is not only more beautiful, it's more valuable, too. Imagine getting a beautiful new bathroom you'll love in just one day. We did it, and so can you, when you call Quick Bath Remodel Center today.
Call 800-870-3137. That's 800-870-3137. 800-870-3137. Call today, 800-870-3137.
The Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference. 13 institutions all striving as one to excel in the classroom and on the field. a premier Division I conference with 16 sponsored sports, showcasing the talents and strengths of our student athletes through hard work and perseverance. The Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, educating student athletes for the game of life.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
This is UMES Basketball on the Hawk Sports Network, powered by SFMSports.net. The all-access halftime show starts now.
Welcome inside our Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report with Maryland Eastern Shore leading 35-33. UMES and Florida A&M are playing a game that is way too eerily similar to the game the Hawks played at Howard last Tuesday. That game had 57 fouls and 39 turnovers in the contest, and both teams flat out stunk from the free throw line that night. Tonight, UMES and Florida A&M combined for 29 fouls in the first half. 29 times two, partner, that's 58. So we're on pace to do that.
We're on pace.
And we had 19 first half turnovers. That means 38 turnovers on pace for the whole game. So again, the numbers are kind of goofy how they're lining up like that. And from the free throw line, the Hawks have shot 68%. Florida A&M 58%. So it's been a poor exhibition of basketball in the first half. Both teams are athletic. Both teams are playing hard, but they're playing out of control, and that's where it's getting frustrating because we're seeing a whole lot of whistles. And again, you know, a lot of people might look at the stats and say, well, boy, could there really been 29 fouls? Yeah, tonight there are. It's not bad officiating. It's just not been a well-played game.
There's probably more fouls, to be honest with you, because both teams have been playing extremely, extremely hard. Like you said, Florida A&M's got nothing to lose, so they're going right after the Hawks. It's been a free-throw shooting contest. And the second half, if it stays close, that's what it'll be. But the free throws for the game, the Rattlers are 11 for 19, the Hawks are 13 for 19, and there goes your two-point advantage with a score 35-33.
Florida A&M's leading scorer is the game's leading scorer, Craig Bowman. 14 first-half points, 4 of 8 shooting, 3 of those buckets were from deep, and he also had 3 free throws. Malcolm Bernard played with 3 fouls in the first half. He only sat for 4 minutes, had 12 points total, 5 rebounds, 2 assists. Bernard had 5 from the free throw line as well. Outside of those two, nobody else really contributed much. In fact, there were only 2 other field goals, Nicholas Severato and Mario Karaliev, the only other 2 baskets from the floor. Florida A&M had 4 assists, 10 turnovers, 1 block, and 4 steals in the first half. They shot 47% from the floor, 4 of 7 from deep, and 58% from the free throw line. Maryland Eastern Shore had 2 scorers at 9 points apiece. Those are Ryan Andino and Devin Martin. Andino got all of his from beyond the three-point line in 14 minutes. Devin Martin played only 9 minutes because he picked up 2 fouls. Devin also had 2 rebounds. The Hawks got 4 points, 4 rebounds, 1 assist, and 1 block shot from Dominique Elliott in 12 minutes. He also had 2 fouls. Makari Copeland had 2 fouls, 4 points, and a rebound, all of them from the free throw line. Shane Randall, 2 points, both from the free throw line. He also had 2 fouls and 2 rebounds. Derek Opek, 12 minutes off the bench. He cashed in 6, but he committed 3 fouls. Isaac Taylor, 3 fouls in just 3 minutes time. The Hawks shot 36%, 9 of 25. They had 7 assists, 9 turnovers, 2 blocks, and 6 steals. The Hawks hit 4 of 13 from deep, 13 of 19 from the strike. So as you look at the numbers, UMES UMES is only slightly better than Florida A&M, and we have just a slight margin, two-point halftime lead.
That's right. And the key to the second half right off the bat is how long Malcolm Bernard can stay in the ball game for the second half. He's got three fouls. If he gets in foul trouble and has to sit, or if he fouls out, it's going to be a tough road to hoe for the Rattlers.
Other side of the coin, if either Elliott or Martin quickly pick up a foul, you know, it might be the same way the other side.
That's correct. But I think the Hawks got a little more depth, believe it or not, than the Rattlers. And both Dominique and Devin getting foul trouble than the Hawks in trouble.
Let's hope that isn't the case. Timeout here on our halftime report. When we come back, we'll look around the MEAC. This is Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Bobby, you here again?
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where you gonna go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Each week, go inside the athletics program at the University of Maryland Eastern Shore with Hawks Talk.
I'm Brendan Gulick, radio voice of the Hawks, and we're joined today by head coach Bobby Collins.
Hear from UMES coaches.
The one thing that we did, we played hard.
Student athletes.
Being a student athlete, obviously, student is first.
We're happy to do it in front of what is a really nice crowd here on Wednesday night at Buffalo Wild Wings on Route 13 in Salisbury. We'll be here from 7 to 8.
It's Hawks Talk from SFMSports.net on Fox Sports 960.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
The Hampton Inn & Suites Fruitland Salisbury South is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you includes a clean, comfortable hotel room, located only 7.5 miles from the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. Also conveniently located within walking distance of 5 different restaurants, plus a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to the campus. Hampton Inn & Suites, an official hotel of UMES Athletics.
The UMES Hawks All-Access Halftime Show continues on SFMSports.net.
Maryland Eastern Shore leads 35-33 over Florida A&M at halftime. A look around the conference where Maryland Eastern Shore has just 2 regular season games remaining after tonight when they play Delaware State and Morgan State. And most of the other teams in that conference have not yet played their 14th game of the year. There's a couple that are also playing their 14th game of the year tonight, but the majority of the conference has more than 2 games left after tonight. So it might serve the Hawks well because they're a little banged up. Even the guys who are playing, there's a difference between playing injured and playing hurt. I think there's a lot of guys that are feeling some bumps and bruises at this point. And so it might be good for the Hawks to get a little R&R, maybe an extra day or two off along the next couple weeks before that tournament.
Usually that's a big benefit to a team during this time of the year. You don't want to get out of the flow, but you don't mind an extra day or two.
Take a look at the conference standings, where Hampton still has a half-game lead at 10-2 over South Carolina State, who came in here on Saturday and won. South Carolina State 10-3. Norfolk State lost to Delaware State on Saturday. They fall to 9-3, and they are a full game out of first place in the conference. You've got Bethune-Cookman hanging in there as well at 8-5. Savannah State checks in at 7-6. Then North Carolina Central at 6-7. Howard at 5-7, North Carolina A&T and Delaware State all at 5-7. Maryland Eastern Shore is 5-8. Coppin State also 5-8. And then Morgan State and Florida A&M are both 3-9. at the conference tonight. South Carolina State is leading Howard late in the first half, 35-29 in Washington, D.C. It's close to being halftime in Baltimore. Morgan State 25, North Carolina A&T 23. At the four-minute mark of the first half, Bethune-Cookman is losing a non-conference game against Stetson, 41-33. Halftime at Delaware State, where Hampton is blowing out the Hornets, 36-20. And a late tip, a game on ESPNU tonight, Norfolk State hosting Coppin State down in Virginia. So right now, Hampton is leading, and it looks like, on paper, that would be an awfully tough game for Delaware State to win. I know they're at home, but Hampton is a far superior team to Delaware State. We'll see if the Hampton Pirates can hang on to that 16-point halftime lead. If they do, the Hampton Pirates are going to put themselves in pretty good spot. Hampton's next game will be on Saturday when they host Howard. And that'll be a conference game, toward the end of the year. Howard at times has looked really good, at times has looked really bad, but they've got excellent guard play, so you never know.
Yeah, that's right. In this league, when your guards play great, you got a good chance to win. And they got a guard that can fill it up, so they got a good chance to win. But Hampton looks like the number one team in the league at this point.
I would say at times that's true. I don't know. I really like the way that Norfolk State plays. I mean, I realize they're a full game out of first place, and I know South Carolina State has also had a great year, but I would say the best team, since this is the last team in the conference, we've now seen them all, I think Norfolk State's the best team in the conference this year.
Yeah, I agree. Any one of those top three could come out of that, but I kind of agree with you.
I mean, their guards are just too good.
Yeah, they're really good.
They shoot the ball unbelievable.
They're really good.
And we'll see.
And they play at a high pace, and they play with a lot of intensity, so that has a tendency. I'm surprised they even lost, three games, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
But we did beat Hampton here at the Hike Center. We do remember that.
Well, we also lost to Delaware State, so you look at it both sides. You beat the first-place team, and at the time, you lost to the last-place team in conference. Just goes to show anybody can win on any given night.
Which tells us it could be wide open at the scope, and no.
Timeout for the final time at halftime. Second half comes your way next. Hawks by two, and we'll be back in just a minute here on the Hawks Sports Network.
Is breakfast really the most important meal of the day? At Buffalo Wild Wings, we think a case can be made for lunch. Think about it. Award-winning hand-spun wings in 16 signature sauces and 5 seasonings, buffalitos, wraps, burgers, and salads. Yeah, we're thinking that's a pretty good argument. Now throw in the fact that we've got over 50 big screens to watch all the sports you'll ever want. It's officially a no-brainer. So next time, make lunch your game-winning meal.
Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Hawks by two as we get ready for the second half. Maryland Eastern Shore has been a really good team at home for most of the year. Florida A&M has not won on the road this season. 0-12. And they are in the ball game here. They had a lead by 5 points at 30-25, but the Hawks closed the first half on a 10-3 run and have a 2-point lead as we start the second half. Florida A&M will have the basketball to get things started, and they'll shoot off to our right in front of their own bench. Away we go. Jaron Foster runs the point. The Hawks come out in a zone defense, and they look as energized as they did all first half, right out of the gate.
Right off the bat.
Foster right wing.
Might have been a good halftime talk.
I hope so. Bowman on the left side holds the ball, gives up top to Bernard. Copeland is all over him. Up top, Foster open for three, and he hit it. That was not good rotation defensively. Foster's triple gives Florida A&M back the lead. 36-35. Here's the Hawks' first possession of the second half.
It's a fifth three-pointer for the Rattlers.
Starting five out there for UMES. Seelan, Martin, Copeland, Randall, and Elliott. As we get a foul underneath the rack. An immediate whistle here in the beginning of the second half. It goes on to Justin Ravenel. His second, team first. Randall off the inbound in the keyhole, threw one toward the corner, turned it over. Bernard was there. Malcolm Bernard all the way up the floor, dribbling with both hands into the right corner. Up to the top of the arc, Foster spot three, just hit one but missed the second. Randall the rebound. Hawks running. Martin right wing double team. Gives up top to Mark Seelan. Mark wants to try the left side. Bounces to Elliott. Turnaround fadeaway. Left baseline jumper is pure from Elliott.
Well, Elliott and Martin ought to be well rested, so they should be able to rock and roll this second half.
Seven lead changes. No, check that. Eight lead changes now in the game. 37-36 Hawks. Bernard top of the arc goes to his right. Bowman has the ball, threw it underneath, looking for Bernard, who had his head turned the wrong way. A turnover for Florida A&M, their 12th.
Quick pass that time by Florida A&M. Good defense by the Hawks that time.
Seelan tries to be authoritative and runs the show offensively. No Rivera on the floor at the moment. Ahmad Frost will miss the rest of the year with a knee injury. Elliott right wing looking around, feeds Randall, open three. Shane can hit it. But he didn't. It bricked off the window. Did not go. Rebound out of bounds to Florida A&M in front of the Hawks bench.
That shot was not close.
I watch him in practice all the time. He loves shooting threes. He's actually probably one of the better pure shooters on the team.
Right.
He just doesn't get a lot of open looks. Hawks up one. Bernard between the circles, checks the clock. 2 minutes ticked off of it. And then an incidentally kicked ball off of Devin Martin. They'll reset the shot clock to 15 seconds. I'm sorry. It's a foul on Shane Randall.
Wow.
Randall just picked up his third. Oh, I thought Devin Martin kicked the ball.
He must have kicked it, but it was after the foul, I guess.
Off the inbound. Bernard at the top of the circle. Looks around, wants to work it inside. Can't find Warren. Bernard again at the top of the arc. From the right elbow, finds Warren on a beautiful feed. He faked like he was going to shoot it to draw the defense in, then passed over the top of him. Warren finished uncontested.
That's a great
38-37.
Assist. That's why he has six or seven assists a game.
Copeland underneath, and a blocking foul is called.
I missed that one myself, but that's all right. We'll take it.
Holy smokes.
I don't know, maybe it was inside the arc underneath the basket.
The Hawks found the genie popping out of the lamp. That was a phantom call if I've ever seen one. But we'll take the benefit. Third on Ravenel. And Copeland has two free throws. Bakari up and good. So three fouls called in the first 2.5 minutes of the second half. Johnson back in there for Ravenel, who has to sit.
And the Rattlers go even smaller. Three guards out there for the Rattlers.
Johnson, a goofy haircut. The sides of his head is buzzed. He's got a long, thick mohawk. Copeland got his own rebound off the miss and one. What a play, Bakari Copeland.
Yeah. The Hawks have definitely got a little more energy this second half.
Second foul on Jaron Foster. Nobody boxed out the shooter
at all.
It's basketball 101.
Yes, it is.
Copeland buries the shot.
What a three-point play.
41-38.
No full-court pressure by the Hawks now.
Johnson had it jarred out of his hand, I guess. He almost traveled with it. Then he went into the backcourt. They missed a backcourt violation. Instead, the jump shot from the left wing was way off from Bowman. Goes back to the Hawks.
And the Hawks are showing the most energy this second half.
Here we go. Hawks by three. Seelan on the right wing. Looking inside. Can't find a way to get it in. Instead, Martin up top for three.
Yeah.
Bang! Devin Martin blowing kisses to the crowd. 44-38 Hawks.
Bernard in the forecourt for Florida A&M. Gives to Jaron Foster. Foster works on Martin, passes to the left corner, and then gets it back from Bowman. Not a lot going on offensively right now. They're just kind of standing around. And finally a foul called away from the basketball on the Hawks. Goes on Mark Seelan.
Hawks playing great defense out there. They don't need to foul. They got Rattlers pushed all the way back, like, way outside the three-point line. Just can't foul.
Isaiah Omoreji checking into the game. He replaces Trevon Warren. From between the circles, Johnson backs toward midcourt. 44-38 Hawks. Bernard on a broken offensive play to the right. Gives off to Bowman, back to Bernard, right corner, drives the baseline. Right to the hoop, two-hand layup up and in. Elliott kind of backed away, didn't want to pick up an unnecessary foul.
Smart move by Don.
Martin runs the floor in transition, now slows up and pulls out. Devin stands right in front of Bobby Collins. Dribbling between his legs, picks up his dribble, feeds Dominique Elliott, right corner. Backdoor cut, Copeland catch, reverse layup with a hand right over his head. That was sick, 46-44.
The Rattlers having a tough time matching up with Copeland. He should have his own way around the basket.
I want to be fair. I said in the first half, Florida A&M group on the floor wanted it more. Right now, the Hawks flat out playing harder.
Yes, correct.
It's just an intensity difference. Omoreji in the paint, turns around and banks it home. A little bump, no call. 46-42 Hawks, 15-27 left. Seelan near midcourt, passes right back to Martin, who goes to Dominique Elliott. Elliott in the right corner, holds it over his head. Ball fakes a couple times, backing down. Passes to Seelan, now left wing Randall. Shane up top to Mark Seelan again. Send to shoot. Seelan wants to weave all the way to the right side, finds Elliott once more. Randall high key, spins out of control, missed the layup. Good move, but out of control. Bernard had it taken out of his hands by Seelan. And Mark gets called for a foul. Boy, I thought he picked the ball clean.
I thought he at least had a jump ball out of him, but he picked it right off of it.
That was one of the best defensive plays Mark Seelan's made in a while. And he got, unfortunately, a tough call that went against him. We've already had six fouls the first 5 minutes of the second half. Hawks 46, Rattlers 42. Back in a moment on the Hawks Sports Network.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
The Courtyard by Marriott on Route 13 in Salisbury offers comfortable rooms and meeting spaces, as well as always superior customer service in a great location near the mall. Call 410-742-4405 and ask for details about their special UMES athletics rate. The Courtyard by Marriott in Salisbury, an official hotel of UMES Athletics and a proud sponsor of Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Hi, this is Bobby Collins, head men's basketball coach of the University of Maryland Eastern Shore Hawks, and you're listening to SFMSports.net.
Maryland Eastern Shore basketball continues tonight. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification here on the Hawks Sports Network. Gulick and Dave Bird with you on a Monday night in the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference. It's UMES 46, Florida A&M 42. A bounce pass off the baseline, inbound goes right back to Johnson, double team in the corner, jump pass to Bernard, who skips the ball over to the left corner. Picked up by Severato, he needs help. He bounces to Johnson on the high left side of the key. Johnson from the keyhole steps and goes by Seelan to the rim, missed it. Copeland rips it away, throws it up the floor, an outlet pass too far in advance of Devin Martin. Well, good to see them both take ownership. Bakari says, my bad. Devin says, no, it was my bad. Well, we don't need to argue about it. That's okay.
They're a little excited out there, which is good. They need to be.
All time. Hawks by four. Johnson on the right wing, looking around, needs some help, tries to go one-on-one against Dominique Elliott. That's a bad mismatch. Bounce pass toward the low right side of the paint, and a missed layup from Omoregi. Oh, my gosh, he was right underneath the hoop.
Point blank.
Could not have been any closer. The other way, Elliott shows him how it's done right down Broadway. 48-42, the big fella connects. Bernard in transition, pulls it out to the right wing, passes back up top. Those are the kind of baskets that haunt you in a close game.
I remember that. That's right.
Driving by the defense, Johnson all the way to the rim. He missed one. On the baseline, got his own rebound. Back to Bernard, who passes left wing. Bowman steps into an 18-footer and buries it. Man.
I think Florida is laying in to change their philosophy a little bit because they had their, you notice they stop it after getting over half court, and they're more going to a more of a half court game instead of a racehorse basketball.
Devin Martin on the left wing, they work it around. Seelan has it up top. A skip pass to Andino. Ryan's on the right wing, dribbles once, passes back to Bakari Copeland, who throws over the head of Elliott underneath. Ryan Andino is calling for it behind him, and Copeland says, hey, man, I didn't see you. My bad.
Copeland's throwing those 110-mile-an-hour fastballs twice in the last two possessions.
48-44 Hawks. Mark Seelan sits. Thomas Rivera back in. Johnson backpedaling his way up the floor. Passes left side. They beat the defense. Bowman left corner three. And he hit it.
Mm-mm-mm. They need to stick with Bowman. He dropped though. He had three threes in the first half.
Bowman makes it 48-47. He's got 19 today. Malcolm Bernard's got 14. Those are easily the two leaders for the Rattlers. Andino tries to answer. Right corner triple. No good. Hawks are struggling from downtown lately. Johnson finds an open teammate. Another three. That was a line drive missile three-pointer from Severato. And just like that, you blink and look at the scoreboard, and the Hawks are down two, 50-48.
Three-point basket gets you right back in there.
We're at the 12:25 mark of the second half. Elliott tried to receive a pass in the paint, and a reach-around foul from Isaiah Omoregi.
And the Rattlers have done it without their leading scorer scoring.
You're right. I think they just charged the foul up on the scoreboard to the wrong person. It's on Isaiah Omoregi. That's his second, team fourth. There we go. They've got that fixed. Jericho Peck back in the game for the Hawks. Ryan Andino sits. Damn. Martin left corner three after a high pass from Copeland. No good. That was probably more the pass than the shot that caused the miss.
Yeah, you're correct.
On the right wing, Severato gives to Johnson among chance of defense from the crowd. Johnson from the keyhole picks up the dribble, finds Severato. Over to the right side now, and Carolee. And did he travel? Yes, he did. Carolee gives it back.
Nice looking little hook shot, but he must have shuffled. Both sides, 15.
Timeout on the floor with 11:55 left in the game. Hawks trail 50-48. It's an 8-2 run for FAMU. Back in a moment here on the Hawks Sports Network.
The Hampton Inn and Suites Fruitland Salisbury South is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you includes a clean, comfortable hotel room located only 7.5 miles from the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. Also conveniently located within walking distance of 5 different restaurants, plus a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to the campus. Hampton Inn and Suites, an official hotel of UMES Athletics.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
Get UMES Hawks basketball anywhere. Listen on your phone with the TuneIn app. Search SFM Sports Channel 2.
Welcome back. The Hawks trail 50-48. Florida A&M and UMES have both shot the ball well in the second half. Maryland Eastern Shores at 56%. Florida A&M 58% in the second half. We've also seen 8 fouls in the second half. Check that, 7 fouls in the second half. Dave, you think this one could come down to free throw shooting?
I think it's going to come down as long as the key players stay in the ball game and stay out of foul trouble.
Florida A&M has not put up a free throw attempt here in half number 2. Hawks have had 2 of 3 in the second half. They're at 68% for the game. Elliott double teamed off the inbound. That was the right move to put him in the backcourt. He finds Blackman, who also draws 2 defenders. Rivero drives up the right side of the floor, avoiding the men in black. Florida A&M black jerseys, black shorts with white letters and green trim. 11:37 left in the game. Hawks second to last regular season home game, and Martin, the senior, puts it in from the left side of the free throw line. Tied at 50.
Hawks, a little defensive pressure, full court, man-to-man.
Devin's got 14 to lead the Hawks. Copeland's got 10, Elliott's got 8. On the right wing, Bowman, who is left-handed, goes behind his back to the right elbow, spins around and lobs toward midcourt and Bernard. Man-to-man defense for the Hawks, 9 to shoot. Bernard works on Elliott, bounces to Carolee. Baseline jumper, left side, air ball. Blackman clears it for the Hawks. They are running. Rivera wants to force the issue. Finds Blackman right wing. Into Elliott. A power dribble and hard to the hoop and a foul.
It's hard to believe. We're almost halfway through the second half and Bernard has not scored for the Rattlers yet. We keep going inside and Elliott is going to make some free throws for us.
Bernard's got 1 basket in the second half.
Did he win?
Yep, just 1. He's got 14 points, had 12 at halftime. It's 4 of 6 shooting in the game. But nonetheless,
very quiet.
He's been quiet. Elliott missed the free throw. Unfortunately, that's been a common theme tonight. He is 2 of 8 at the line. To give the Hawks the lead, the gym falls quiet. And the free throw's good. Tickles the twine on the way down. 51-50. UMES with 10:50 to play. Right wing Ravenel. Runs into the corner. Uses his free hand to push Mark Blackman away from him. Picks up the dribble. Needs help. Whoa. It deflected off of Rivera. Yeah. Out of bounds. That was the right call.
Yeah, he got it back. Good hustle by the Hawks. Defensive intensity has picked up tremendously the second half.
It sure has. Bernard inbounds into the backcourt. Foster with his back to the basket, faces up, passes a bounce pass left side. Working at the right elbow, hanging out, needing some help, and Ravenel, 5-second call. Blackman all over him. Peck was there too. 51-50 UMES.
Defense, absolutely unbelievable.
Thomas Rivera to the right half of the floor. Looking up top, Devin Martin wanted to catch and shoot. Couldn't let the three fly. Jump stop in the paint, Peck hard to the rim, blocked by Bernard into the backboard. Malcolm looking up the floor, and he lost the handle. Picked up by Blackman, 3-on-2. Martin left corner, started to slip, picked up the ball, needs some help, found Blackman. Right side, Rivera pushed it. He got blocked. Severato blocked it. Denied twice by Florida A&M Bigs.
Back-to-back blocks by the Rattlers.
Ravenel in the right corner fakes, and they work around the arc. Elliott picks it away on a cross-court pass. Dominique shows off the handles. Fakes and goes to the rim. Elliott coast to coast.
And Bernard had to let him go. Bernard let him go because he's worried about getting his 4th foul.
9:23 to play. Hawks by 3. And a timeout on the floor. I think it's a 30-second timeout.
Yeah.
And there will become a media timeout. UMES 53, Florida A&M 50. Back in a moment on the Hawks Sports Network.
Have you heard? Proactive is new and better than ever. Stay tuned for a million bottle giveaway, and you'll also receive free shipping. Do you have troubled skin, acne? Well, we have great news. With new Proactive, your acne can heal and you can prevent new breakouts from happening. Be one of the first to try it by giving us a call at 1-800-669-8096. Because we're going to let a million people try new Proactive risk-free. Get two free gifts and also receive free shipping when you call right now. You heard it. Be one of the first to try new and better than ever Proactive, and you'll receive a 60-day risk-free trial of the new Proactive, two free extras, and free shipping when you call 1-800-669-8096. This is our best radio offer ever. Get your risk-free 60-day trial of new Proactive plus free shipping. That's right, free shipping. This offer won't last long. Call 1-800-669-8096. That's 1-800-669-8096.
Maryland Eastern Shore with a three-point lead just past the midway point of the second half. Florida A&M has not won a road game all year. You start to feel for them. Heck, you kind of know how they feel because UMES has only won twice on the road this year. They won at Coppin State and they won at American University. And that's it, 2-17 away from this building. Circling into the left corner, a three and a bucket. Justin Ravenel was wide open, tied it up, 53-0.
The Hawks are playing very, very hard, but the Rattlers just will not go away.
Elliott gives to Peck, who cut to the basket back door. Elliott was in the left corner, and Peck came flying in, avoiding the defense. 55-53, Derek O'Peck has 8 points. One of the better shooters in the conference in terms of field goal percentage. Going to the hoop to the left side, Foster needs some help. He was bumped around in the corner. Foster high in the key, fakes twice, gives off. Jump shot left baseline good from 10 feet away. Nicholas Severato's got 8 points.
Severato shoots that line drive jump shot.
Yeah, he had a three-point shot that I think at its apex got maybe 10 and a half feet in the air.
You're right.
Rivera bounces to Elliott just inside the arc right corner. Pumps and then shoots and buries it. 57-55, UMES, 8:10 left in the game. Hawks have three timeouts left. Florida A&M has two. Hawks racing back defensively. Three ball left wing. Another one from Ravenel. 58-57. Hawks down one at the 7:53 mark. Rivera dribbling along the right wing, looking inside where Martin sets a screen, tries to free up Elliott, and I think Elliott was fouled underneath. I believe it goes on Mario Carolee.
Elliott trying to get in position on the low box, and Carolee just pushing him way out.
Media timeout. It's our under eight stoppage with the Hawks down one, 58-57. This is the Hawks Sports Network tonight through SFMSports.net.
The Mideastern Athletic Conference. 13 institutions all striving as one to excel in the classroom and on the field. A premier Division I conference with 16 sponsored sports showcasing the talents and strengths of our student athletes through hard work and perseverance. The Mideastern Athletic Conference, educating student athletes for the game of life.
Speed kills. Over 30% of all traffic deaths are caused by speed. Speeding increases both stopping distances and the chances of serious injury and death. Speeding is aggressive driving. That's why area police in D.C. and Maryland are stopping and ticketing speeders and aggressive drivers. The Smooth Operator Program is back in D.C. and Maryland. Speeding stops here. SmoothOperatorProgram.com.
Maryland Eastern Shore trails 58-57, thanks in large part to Florida A&M's deep ball shooting tonight. On the year, they average just under 6 3 balls a game, and they shoot it at just over a 30% clip. Tonight, they've hit 9 of 13. That's 69% from downtown. 4 for Bowman, 2 for Ravenel.
Foster, Bernard, and Severato all at one as well. The Hawks got to play better perimeter defense if they want to win this at home. Leading score in the game, 19 from Craig Bowman. Hawks have the ball, down one. Martin shooting at the basket off to the left at the top of the arc, circles to the hoop, and does a great job switching hands midair but missed the layup. Tipped once, controlled by Florida A&M. Bowman pressured in the backcourt along with Malcolm Bernard. Bernard gives to Bowman, top of the arc. Finds Foster left wing. Jaron Foster checks inside, bounces up top instead. Now Bernard, high key, spins to the basket. Faced up, went hard, lost the ball. Jumping up and down in disbelief at the lack of a call is head coach Byron Samuels. Runner missed from the right wing. Samuels is livid.
They've been going through the lane. I don't know. They haven't been calling out the entire ball game.
Hawks get it back down one, and Elliott throws one off a Rattler hand out of bounds.
And Bernard continues to be quiet for the Rattlers throughout this second half, and a couple of the guys have stepped up. Dominic Elliott has stepped up for the Hawks.
Rivera looking to inbound, gets it to Elliott underneath, and he's hit. Thomas Rivera does the right thing. Couldn't find anyone to get it in, so he forced it to Elliott, who was literally almost out of bounds. And Warren was standing right on top of Elliott. Trayvon Warren just picked up his third personal, and that's the seventh foul of the half on Florida A&M. These two teams have played slightly better defense here in the second half. Bowman has a discussion with Victor Montgomery, one of the two officials. Elliott's free throw is good. 4 of 10 tonight from the line. Elliott's got 14 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists. Martin's got 14. Copeland has 10. Tom shimmies the shoulders, puts up the free throw, and buries it. 59-58, Hawks. 6:49 to play as everybody slaps the floor defensively. Foster into the forecourt. Crowd getting into it. Foster looking around, wants to go right against the zone. Bowman lobs it over the top of the defense to Foster left side. Bounce pass to Bernard, left elbow. Slams a pass to the right corner for a Bowman three. No. Elliott grabs the board high. Here's Rivera up the floor for the Hawks. Trying to add to a one-point lead. Copeland around the right block. Hooks around the defender, forced it up. It did not roll home. Martin was there for the rebound. It lost on the floor. And then Florida A&M picks it up. Here's Bowman up the floor, 4-on-4. Into the left corner. Ravenel, triple, no. Elliott a good box out. He grabs the board. Finds an outlet pass left wing and Martin. Devin slows it up. Back to the basket, looks towards his guards. Devin wants to take charge. Finds Copeland underneath. Bakari goes up and under. 61-58.
Great job by Devin Martin that time, controlling the offense from the free throw line, hitting Bakari on a cut to the basket.
Copeland's got 12 on 3 of 6 shooting and 6 of 7 free throws. Ravenel passes left side to Bowman. Bowman, entry pass, high key, turns into a jump shot from Warren, no good. Elliott, another rebound. Dominique's got 7 tonight.
The Hawks defense is making other players on the Rattlers shoot the ball beside Bernard.
Hawks have all the momentum, but just a three-point lead. They have got to put Florida A&M away because this team has proven they can shoot the ball tonight. Rivera on the right wing. Pulls to the top of the arc. Bounces to Blackman, left side, 5 to shoot. Mark, no-look pass underneath. Elliott tried not to step on Warren, and it altered his shot. He missed the layup. All the way up the floor, and an offensive foul. Thomas Rivera set those feet, and he drew it beautifully.
Great play Foster. By Rivera that time. Defensive stance outside the ring, underneath the basket.
Foster picked up his third. Mark Blackman with good minutes for the Hawks off the bench tonight. Derek Opeck comes back in.
Martin getting a little blow. It won't be long.
Rivera helping wipe up the floor in the backcourt. It's Rivera, Copeland, and Dino Peck and Elliott. We are exactly at the 5-minute mark of the second half. UMES 61, Florida A&M 58. Rivera dribbling on the right half of the floor, watching a 2-3 zone defense. As they get set up, Andino has it left wing, bounces to Elliott, who goes to Copeland in the corner. Bakari lobs it back to Dom. Dom, 16 to shoot, hands to Bakari as he cut to the basket. The ball rolls out of bounds and stays with the Hawks. That jarred right out of his hand, and I guess deflected off of Rattler.
A little give and go with Elliott and Bakari Copeland.
Rivera to inbound. He gets it to Derrico Peck. Derrico back to Thomas, right wing. 11 on the shot clock. Rivera looking around, back to Copeland. Copeland wants to go to the right corner, 6 to shoot. Backing down, spins baseline, and he definitely cleared out with his free hand. That's an offensive foul.
That's pretty easy to call on that baseline when you're right in front of the official.
Second, no, I think it's his third foul. Yeah, third foul on Bakari Copeland. So Bakari sits down, and Devin Martin comes back in. Just a quick cup of coffee over there on the bench.
Not much a breather for Devin.
Well, if you were tired early in the game, you can't be now, because this one has you on the edge of your seat. A deflection out of bounds. Florida A&M keeps it. It's in front of their own bench, a sideline inbound. 4:19 to play. Hawks by 3, 16 on the shot clock. Bowman's been outstanding tonight with 19. He's hit 4 three balls. And Dino's had a decent night from deep for the Hawks. He's hit 3 of them. 5 to shoot. Johnson up top. Has to force it left lane. Made way to the basket, and he'll go to the free throw line. That was the right play by Johnson to force his way to the strike. We played almost 16 full minutes of the second half, and these are the first free throws the entire half for Florida A&M after putting up 19 free throws in the opening frame.
So the Hawks have played better defense.
Derrico Peck just picked up his fourth foul. Copeland will come back. So will Carolee. Johnson's free throw toss is too far to the left. No good. So Derrico Peck sits down. Hawks are showing some unity right now on both ends of the floor. Trying to bear down here defensively. Johnson trying to split the pair, and he does. 61-59, 4:04 left in the game. Rivera across the timeline into the forecourt on the right wing. Hawks are wearing their white jerseys tonight. Rivera has it. Andino running the baseline. Thomas holding the ball. He bounces into the right corner to Dominique Kelly. Skip pass to the left wing. Dominique gives it off to Devin Martin. Gets it right back. Puts up a bank shot from the left elbow and bricked it way too hard off the backboard.
That's a tough shot going away from the basket.
Florida A&M could tie or take the lead, down 2 with 3:35 to play. Shooting off to our right. A jump pass from the right elbow to the left wing. Johnson drives, the floater, no. Carolee, the offensive rebound, and Elliott fouled him. Dominique was there for the rebound, but he just mistimed his jump, and Carolee was there to pull it in. Elliott picks up his third foul, just his first of the whole second half. And we've got our final timeout on the floor. UMES 61, Florida A&M 59. We'll be back to buckle in for the final 3:26. This is the Hawk Sports Network from SFMSports.net.
Bobby, you here again?
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of 7 entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of 7 sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
How you doing? This is Devin Martin, senior guard from Maryland Eastern Shore, and you're now tuning in to Hawk Sports Network.
Well, they're having fun inside the Hike Center with the Hawks up 61-59 over Florida A&M. This is a tight game late. The Hawks have all 3 timeouts that they brought into the second half still in their back pocket. 2 timeouts left for Florida A&M. The Rattlers, who are ineligible for postseason play, had just a couple games left on the schedule. This is their only matchup with the Hawks this year. And for a group that has shown some promise, a couple of seniors like Jaron Foster and Mario Karaliev, this is kind of their last go-round. Karaliev is at the free throw line. The big left-handed center puts up the free throw and got it. 61-60. The Hawks have been great at home. Rattlers have been terrible on the road, 0-12.
Right, and the Hawks have shot free throws better than the Rattlers. So
to tie the game, he hit it. And a substitution as Karaliev leaves, and Butler, check that up, Bernard comes back in. We are tied at 61 with 3:26 to play in the game. A full court press put on by the men in black and green. Rivera was, oh boy, he traveled.
Nope.
Maybe you had a better sight line than I did on that. I thought maybe he got bumped.
He traveled first.
Okay.
He was trying to throw it off a guy's leg.
It was good press in the backcourt. Rivera tried to go on the sideline. 3:19 and counting. Tied at 61. The Hawks lost earlier this year to Delaware State and are trying to avoid desperately to losing to Florida A&M as Bowman goes through the left leg. And he's got 21 with that inbound, or I should say with that left-handed layup. Pressure on the inbound. Elliott needs some help in the backcourt. Under 3 minutes to play as Copeland is trapped across midcourt. Lost the ball and a foul, I think, on Dominique Elliott.
Yep.
You bet. Elliott just picked up his fourth and his second foul within the last minute of the second half.
Let's go. Bakari got in trouble dribbling the ball before and stopped at the no man's land around midcourt there. Got double teamed and then a tough pass to Elliott. Dominique come from behind.
Dominique's got four fouls as the free throw on 1-1 is good for Justin Ravenel, the freshman. He's had a good game. Hawks are down three. They were up two. Bucket is good. It's a nice little run now. Six straight points for Florida A&M.
Very quick.
Copeland inbounds to Elliott, who finds Rivera middle of the floor. Thomas beats the defense up into the right corner. Martin was open. Passed up the shot. They work to Andino. Left block to Copeland. Back to Martin. Up top for three. No good. Elliott the jump and the putback didn't go. He got his own rebound again. Forced it up. And that one finally rolled home. Timeout. Hawks 65-63 with 2:37 to play. Dominique went to work in that low post and just out-hustled and out-muscled everybody.
Out-hustled everybody inside. Great offensive rebound. Controlled himself. Went straight back up and got his own shot. 2 points.
Final home game of the regular season will be our next contest on Saturday when the Hawks host Delaware State. They will only have one game left in the regular season after Saturday. That's Thursday, March 3rd at Morgan State. So just two games left after tonight. Delaware State, who's put together a couple nice games of late. Obviously, their most notable win came against Norfolk State on Saturday this weekend.
Yes.
Hard to believe that happened.
That's a big win.
67-64. It's a huge win.
That's a big win.
And it's as big a win for Del State as it is a loss for Norfolk. Yeah,
that's true.
Hawks down two. 2:33 to play at home against Florida A&M. The Rattlers work the left side of the floor. They are a very athletic group who have shot the ball very well tonight. 9 of 16 threes. They average just under 6 a game. But they've missed their last three triples. 10 to shoot, 2:15 to play. On the right wing, Ravenel dribbles twice, gives it off. Top of the floor, Bernard goes to work, pulls up from deep, and he missed it. Tipped around twice under the basket. It stays in bounds, and Elliott comes to get it, and he's fouled. Oh, that was a sloppy foul by Florida A&M because the Hawks will shoot 1-1.
And the clock stopped and everything.
Goes on Johnson, his first, team ninth. 2:04 left in the game. That was the last thing you wanted to do if you were the Rattlers.
Yeah. Yes. Great for the Hawks.
Elliott could tie the game. Tonight has been tough from the line. 5 of 11. The free throw is up and good. He's 6 of 12. Elliott with 17 points, 10 rebounds. He's got his ninth double-double of the season. Takes his time from the free throw line. Dominique waiting to go to tie the game. Got it.
Yeah, nice looking free throw.
65-65 after a tough start. He's rebounded nicely. We are tied with 2 minutes to play at home.
And the Hawks are in his own.
Right wing Bowman gives up top to Bernard. He holds out fingers in the air to call out the play. Barking to Bowman, who gives to Johnson. Johnson on the right wing against the zone defense. Dribbles to the top between the circles, wants to go to work. Crossover step back, gives back up top. Ravenel pulls up, five to shoot, and he can't hit a three. Bernard, the offensive rebound. Timeout, Florida A&M, with 1:31 left on the clock. Good there defensively.
That's right.
They just didn't come up with a rebound.
Yeah, unfortunately, when you shoot those long threes, that ball could bounce anywhere. Yeah, so it's just very unlucky to not to get that rebound. Great defensive job. Force them out. Force them to take a quick shot before the shot clock ran out. Long jump shot, but just did not corral the offensive and defensive rebound.
65-65. Florida A&M has one timeout remaining. Hawks with two left. 1:31 to go. I don't know if anybody really expected this game to be so tight with the way the Hawks at one point had looked like they were starting to run away with it a little bit, but I don't know.
Well, 65-65 with a minute 31. We're looking at somebody making three throws down this last stretch, or you and I are in OT.
We've only had one overtime game this year on the men's side.
That's right, we were
at Coppin. No, is that Coppin State?
Yeah, I thought we were here in.
Morgan State was a close game.
That
it was a four-point game.
That was when you had radio trouble.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and in fact, I couldn't get on there for that game. So on the men's side, we haven't called an overtime game.
I wonder. I couldn't remember.
Feels like the women have had four or five.
That's what I'm thinking of.
So here we go. Both teams in the bonus. The next foul on FAMU will give the Hawks two free throws. Johnson in the forecourt, guarded by Blackman. Ooh. Rivera, Peck, Elliott, and Martin also out there. Tied at 65. Can hear the chance for the defense on the home floor. Bowman with a game-high 21 to the rim. Left side, drew contact, no foul. Got his own rebound and then got hit. Man, I'll tell you what, Byron Samuels has to be careful he doesn't get a technical foul. He is about as hot as you can be.
That's why all the assistant coaches are standing in front of him.
They're standing in front of him. They made him sit down. Right. Howard Davis, the official, standing over there. He's got his hand on his chin going, tempt me. I dare you.
It was called, sir. All three assistants up there in front of him.
Bowman at the free throw line, where he's a 66% free throw shooter, and he hits the first. 1 point lead for Florida A&M. Let's see who comes on the floor and who comes off. We'll reset the lineups for you as Kara Leave is out there with Bowman, Bernard, Johnson, and Ravenel, Andino, Rivera, Martin, Copeland, Elliott out there for the Hawks. 2 point ball game, 67-65. Both free throws good from Bowman. Here we go. Copeland in the backcourt at the free throw line. Needs some help. Lobs it toward the left wing. Martin all the way to the hoop. Sidesteps into trouble and drew a foul. Kara Leave put his arm up. Martin got hit. 107 to play. Hawks down two. And with two Martin free throws, they could tie the game. Devin has hit two of two from the line tonight. 14 points, three rebounds, two assists for Devin Martin.
And he's the guy we wanted to line. Good play by the senior.
Devin lives for these kinds of moments. And the first free throw up and good. As confident a player as you're going to find. Kara Leave leaves the floor. Severato back in there. He's probably a better offensive player.
It's offense, defense is what's going on there.
This would tie the game for Martin. It's up. And good. 67-67. Blackman and Peck back in. Copeland and Andino out.
Little offense, defense for the Hawks.
1 minute and 5 seconds to play. Tied at 67. Here we go. Left wing, Bernard dribbles to the top of the circle, passes right wing. Bowman dribbling against Eric Opek, probably the best athletic defender for the Hawks. Weave around the top. Bernard has it deflected into the post. Elliott pulls away the turnover. 45 seconds to play. The Hawks want to set up a play. They will not call timeout yet. And now they do. They had to dribble the ball back in front of Coach Collins so they could dribble up the play they want. We are tied at 67 with 40.7 left. There's 21 seconds left in the shot clock, and the Hawks will burn a full timeout. We'll take it with them. UMES and Florida A&M in a barn burner late. Back in just a moment on the Hawks Sports Network.
Bobby, you here again?
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I could finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Each week, go inside the athletics program at the University of Maryland Eastern Shore with Hawks Talk.
I'm Brendan Gulick, radio voice of the Hawks, and we're joined today by head coach Bobby Collins.
Hear from UMES coaches.
The one thing that we did, we played hard.
Student athletes.
Being a student athlete, obviously, student is first.
We're happy to do it in front of what is a really nice crowd here on Wednesday night at Buffalo Wild Wings on Route 13 in Salisbury. We'll be here from 7 to 8.
It's Hawks Talk from SFMSports.net on Fox Sports 960.
67-67 with 40 seconds left in the game. UMES and Florida A&M tied at home. Alongside Dave Bird, I'm Brendan Gulick. This is the third to last regular season game for the Hawks, who've dropped four in a row after winning four in a row, trying to get back into rhythm here late in the season. Rivera on the right wing for Coach Collins' group. Bounces up top to Martin. Devin goes to the left side into the high key. Elliott goes to work, a drop step, a hook shot, no. Shot clock is off. Florida A&M has it. Fouls would show for free throws the rest of the way, and Florida A&M will have the last look. 15 seconds to play. Johnson at midcourt. And timeout called for by Florida A&M. They wanted to wait till they had 10.6 on the clock.
That's a little late, in my opinion. 10.6, you got to go right away to the basket. You have to set up out-of-bounds play. If you went a little earlier, you could bring the ball out and set up your half-court offense.
Was it the best look the Hawks have had all game? No. Was it a bad look? No. You got it in the paint. Yeah. You had your best player who's had the best game today in Dominique Elliott. He was a little off balance, but I don't think he forced the shot. No. I don't want to over-critique it. It was a decent look.
It just didn't go. Inside the lane. He just missed it. We didn't come up with the offensive rebound. Almost.
So Florida A&M takes the timeout. It's their last. They are looking for their first road victory of the year. Peck, Rivera, Elliott, Martin, and Blackman out there for the Hawks. For FAMU on the floor. Bowman, Ravenel, Johnson, Bernard, and Foster. Five shooters.
And the Hawks are playing man-to-man defense.
Sideline inbound goes into Johnson near midcourt. Johnson puts it on the deck. Seven to shoot.
Going over top.
Over to the left side. He's got an open lane, and he lays it. No good. Oh, my gosh. He missed a wide open layup to win the game.
He missed it.
No way.
Oh, my land.
Woo. I mean, the defense parted like the Red Sea, and he missed it right at the rim. Wow!
For a finger roll, and it hit off of the back of the rim.
The Hawks got a serious break.
That doesn't even come close. We've got overtime at home. 67-67. Back after this timeout, this is the Hawks Sports Network from SFMSports.net.
The Hampton Inn & Suites Fruitland Salisbury South is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you includes a clean, comfortable hotel room located only 7.5 miles from the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. Also conveniently located within walking distance of 5 different restaurants, plus a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to the campus. Hampton Inn & Suites, an official hotel of UMES Athletics.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
This is Hawks Basketball from sfmsports.net.
40 minutes, not enough tonight. UMES and Florida A&M tied at 67 as we head to overtime. Foul trouble is definitely going to come into play. There are a bunch of guys with three. Peck and Elliott each have four as the tip is controlled by Florida A&M. Each team is awarded an additional timeout, so the Hawks have two. Florida A&M has one. 67-67. Nobody feels worse than KJ Johnson,
wow,
who missed the game time or the game-winning layup right at the buzzer. Johnson has it left wing, fakes, passes to the corner. Ravenel triple is too long. Rebound tipped twice, controlled by FAMU. They've got it on the right wing. A second chance. Bowman lobs to the corner. Ravenel right back to Bowman. Bowman's got 23 to lead all scorers. Elliott 19 and 10, the leader of the Hawks. Bernard passes right side. Back to Bowman. Left-handed shooter on the right wing. Bounce pass to the left-hand side of the floor. Calls for it back. Catch and shoot three. And it swirled twice around and popped away. Man, you can't make some of this stuff up. This has been crazy down the stretch.
It's the Hawks' game to win.
Rivera in the forecourt, trying to will his team to victory. Passes to Martin, left side, who wants to drive, pulls up from 15, and buries it on the baseline. He's limping as he runs back defensively. 69-67, the Hawks, as Devin
cramping.
Yeah, he's kind of tugging at his hamstring and knee. He's waving at Bobby Collins to say, don't take me out. I think you're right. I think he's just cramping a little bit. He goes for a play up top, and he commits a foul on Johnson.
That's an injury foul. A little bit late there.
1-1 coming.
That was a foul.
Devin's going, I didn't touch it.
Well,
hate to break it to you, Devin, but you did.
I know, right out in front of everybody.
His third, team ninth. Johnson for a 1-1, trying to redeem himself. First one rattles its way home. 69-68, UMES. Wow. Johnson to tie the game. Missed it. Elliott grabs his 11th rebound of the night. Here comes Thomas Rivera to run the point guard. He holds four fingers in the air. Copeland, Andino, Elliott, and Martin out there with Rivera.
Yeah, that means a 1-4 offense.
Yep, and a 2-3 zone defense. Andino on the right wing, bounces it up top to Rivera. Thomas looks for a driving lane, goes down the middle. They work it back to Andino, open three. He hit it! Andino with his 4th three-point basket of the night. Johnson.
That were a two-possession game.
72-68 as Johnson brought it up over the timeline. Right corner. Ravenel bounces back to Johnson, right wing. Outside the perimeter, looking inside. He goes to Bowman, who threw it toward the paint, deflected and held. Into the left corner now. Ravenel, a three. No. Martin leaps up for the rebound and tells everybody, hold on, let's be smart. Hawks by 4, 72-68 with 2:40 to play. And all the momentum is on the side of the Hawks after Johnson missed the game-winning layup attempt for FAMU at the buzzer. Rivera passes to Andino on the left wing. Whoa. Ryan's got 12. He nearly throws a skip pass out of bounds. 5 to shoot for Martin. Raises. Foot on the line. Airballs it. Rebound pulled in by Malcolm Bernard. Bernard, the leader of Florida A&M in every category this year. Goes to Bowman, who drives the baseline and draws Elliott's 5th foul. That's it. Dominique Elliott fouls out of the game with 2 minutes and 13 seconds left in overtime. Elliott will finish with 19 points, 12 rebounds, 4 assists, 2 steals, and a block.
Had a nice game, but we need him on the floor now.
This is big. Derek Opek is going to take his spot. A couple substitutions for both teams, so we'll reset the lineups for you. Foster, Ravenel, Bernard, Bowman, and I can't see who's on the other side there. It is Nicholas Severato. Okay, so those five are out there for Florida A&M. Rivera, Andino, Martin, Copeland, and Derek Opek.
And Bernard's been stuck on 14 points for the entire second half.
First free throw from Bowman did not go. Right. Coach Collins yelling, box out, box out. They want to make sure they clear out the shooter.
The difference in the ball game right here, Florida.
72-68.
Not a good three-point shooting team.
The shot is up and missed it again. FAMU tonight has hit just 19 of 32 from the line. Martin in the forecourt gives to Derek Opek with a 4-point lead and 2 minutes to play. Both teams in the double bonus the rest of the way. Andino up top to Devin Martin. They weave around to the left side and now Rivera. He holds it at his right hip, 10 to shoot. Martin comes back to the ball. Dominique Elliott's already fouled out. The Hawks are without their big man. Martin with 4 to shoot. Forced to the left elbow, put it up, and he traveled.
He should have shot it over top the small guard or taken a small guard to the left. They needed to clear out for him.
It was probably a case of trying to do a little too much.
Too much, that's correct. But we did run some clock.
Yes, we did.
We run some clock.
142 and counting. Foster in the forecourt. He's had a decent ball game himself. Foster gets the ball right back after passing off. Here's Ravenel, who's got a couple of threes tonight. Foster from the left elbow. Hands the ball over to Bowman. Bowman back to Foster, left corner, 12 to shoot. Foster to the top of the key, an open Bernard. Fakes to the corner, drives down the right lane, up and in. Malcolm Bernard, just his second basket of the half. He's got 16 tonight. Rivera pressed in the backcourt, 1:13 to play. Hawks lead 72-70. Rivera all the way up, hands to Copeland, who's fouled, but it does not go. Oh, he was right under the hoop, and it didn't fall in. Bad roll. So the foul is on Bernard, his fourth.
Good take by Rivera that time. He saw the opening, and Copeland sitting on the left block. Bakari just could not follow through after being fouled.
So Bakari Copeland with critical free throws tonight. He's at 6 of 7, and you can add one more. It's a 3-point lead, 73-70 for UMES. We were tied at 67 when we went to overtime. The Hawks got real lucky at the end of regulation as Copeland hits that one too, and UMES calls a timeout. So they burn one of their two remaining timeouts, and it becomes a media stoppage. 74-70 UMES with 1:09 to play on the Hawks Sports Network.
Delmarva Power has two new ways for customers to save money and energy this summer.
There is always something on in our house.
Washer, dryer, and in the summertime, the air conditioner.
The Peak Energy Savings Credit is a hands-on way for all customers to save money and energy. When a peak savings day happens, make simple changes like waiting a few hours before doing laundry, using a barbecue grill, and more to earn bill credits. We'll even notify you the night before a peak savings day so you'll be ready to save.
I'm always looking for ways to save.
Energy Wise Rewards is the automatic way for customers to save money and energy.
Automatic works for me.
On a peak savings day, your central air conditioner or your heat pump will be automatically cycled off and on for short periods. And the difference in temperature is just a few degrees, so you can stay comfortable. So sign up and get started saving today.
We know that people want to save.
Visit delmarva.com/peak to learn more.
This is Hawks Basketball from sfmsports.net.
Let's give you a reset inside the Heights Center. UMES 74, Florida A&M 70. The Hawks have lost Dominique Elliott for the game. He fouled out with 19 points and 12 rebounds, his ninth double-double of the season. Devin Martin with 18 points on 6 of 11 shooting. Bakari Copeland, 14 points on 3 of 6 shooting. Those two that are still in, Martin and Copeland, have combined to hit 12 of 13 free throws tonight on a night where the Hawks as a team have struggled at times, but lately they've been money. 24 of 32 now on the evening after hitting just 13 of 19 in the first half. Craig Bowman with a game-high 23. He's got 4 threes for Florida A&M. Malcolm Bernard, their best player, has 16 points tonight and 12 boards. With 1 minute to play, the Hawks lead by 4. On the right wing, Florida A&M has the ball. Bowman lobs to the left side and Johnson. Johnson missed the game-winning layup at the buzzer of regulation. He drives right to the hoop and gets fouled here with 50.5 left in the game.
Hardly no time in the shot clock.
Foul goes on Bakari Copeland. He just picked up his 4th. So Johnson will shoot a couple. There's not a big crowd here tonight, but they are getting loud. And Johnson hits it from the line. That's a big one, 74-71.
One possession game.
Each team still has one timeout remaining. Blackman checks out, Andino back in as the crowd gets wild with Johnson stepping to the line. Right-handed free throw is up, and it's good. 74-72, and now Mark Blackman checks back into the game for Derek Opek. So you've got basically 5 good ball handlers right on the floor, but your biggest player out there is Bakari Copeland at 6'6". We're over at the scores table for a minute. I'm not sure what the issue is.
Make sure we got the correct sub in.
Is he not allowed to sub in? I don't know what the problem was. Blackman was there waiting. I guess Mark Blackman can't come in yet. Derek Opek's still out there. So forget what I said about Copeland being the biggest guy out there. Opek a little bigger. Here comes the inbound to Rivera. He's triple-teamed in the backcourt. Thomas Rivera spinning around, throws it wildly to Martin. That's a lucky break. Devin crosses midcourt, up by 2. He's double-teamed left sideline, tucks the ball in, and he had it picked out of his pocket. Johnson throws over left side. Ravenel to the rim, lays it in, tie game. Why didn't they call timeout? On the inbounds pass, the Hawks to midcourt. Copeland has it in front of his own bench. They lost the ball before the Hawks could call timeout. Florida A&M pounces on it. They call timeout. 26.9 left. UMES down the stretch offensively. Holy completely God. Let their guard down.
Right. And they were double and triple teamed and still tried to handle the ball. And lost it.
There were 2 different times the Hawks should have called timeout.
You got to remember now, the player's got to call it.
It's true.
So somebody's got to go to an official here. That's got to happen.
The shot clock has 25 seconds on it, though I don't know why, because there's no way that 5 seconds ticked off from the time Florida A&M dove on it. I think the shot clock should be off.
Yeah,
we'll see what they choose to do. What I can tell you is even if they leave it like this, there's virtually no difference. And so they could basically hold for another game-winning basket attempt. 26.9 to play. Florida A&M was down 74-70 30 seconds ago and has pulled 2 quick buckets out of completely thin air.
Might as well get fouled in this one.
They will leave 25 seconds on the shot clock. Bernard to inbound in front of the scores table, gets it to Bowman. Here we go. Tied at 74, and FAMU will have another chance to win it at the end of overtime if they take care of the ball.
Ooh.
They're out of timeouts. 15 seconds to play. Tied at 74. Bernard in front of his own bench, left wing. Everybody clearing away. 5 seconds to shoot, 7 to play. Bernard from the left elbow, missed it short. Martin the rebound, and we've got double overtime. Nope, the Hawks got a timeout with 0.8 left. There's 0.8 left on the clock. Bernard had a wide open look, and he just didn't push it very hard. It was short out of his hand.
It never made it close to the basket.
We'll see if they choose to put more time on the clock. They could review this if they'd like.
Yeah. It was not like there was the previous miss. That ball had no chance of going in.
The Hawks have used their last timeout. They've got a baseline inbound, and they've got to go the entire length of the floor. There's 0.8 on the clock, and the officials have not elected to go to the monitor. So if you're Florida A&M in a tie game right now, you put your tallest unit on the floor, especially your best guy, who you could have in defend that inbounds pass.
On the ball. And he can't move.
UMES will put out on the floor Copeland, Andino, Rivera, Martin, and they're missing somebody. Mark Blackman. Here we go. So it's five good shooters. Bakari Copeland will inbound. There's 0.8 seconds left in overtime. Copeland looking around. He's got to hold his spot. The inbound defender is Severato. They give it to Andino, and they basically say, let's just play for double overtime.
Yeah. This is trying to take a chance at doing something.
Unbelievable. Wow, what a finish to this game. And we're not done. UMES and Florida A&M need a second overtime. Back in a moment. This is the Hawks Sports Network from SFMSports.net.
Bobby, you here again?
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Each week, go inside the athletics program at the University of Maryland Eastern Shore with Hawks Talk.
I'm Brendan Gulick, radio voice of the Hawks, and we're joined today by head coach Bobby Collins.
Hear from UMES coaches.
The one thing that we did, we played hard.
Student athletes.
Being a student athlete, obviously, student is first.
We're happy to do it in front of what is a really nice crowd here on Wednesday night at Buffalo Wild Wings on Route 13 in Salisbury. We'll be here from 7 to 8.
It's Hawks Talk from SFMSports.net on Fox Sports 960.
Man, what a night. 74-74 after our first overtime of the evening. The Hawks played an overtime game at Coppin State a couple of weeks ago. That was their only other overtime affair of the season. They won that game 83-81 in double OT. Tonight, a 74-74 score as we start our second overtime without Dominique Elliott. We'll see if the Hawks can rely on their guards here at home. Their big man fouled out with 19 and 12, and all he can do is anxiously and nervously, probably more accurately, sit on the bench and watch. Peck wins the opening tip. The Hawks control going right to left in overtime number two. 74-74. Martin on the left wing. Circles up top. Goes to the right side of the key. Blocked on the layup. Pulled right out of the air. Nicely blocked by Severato. Up the floor on offense. Malcolm Bernard goes to his left. Passes off to Bowman. Then right back to Bernard. Right wing. Looking in the key. Good interior defense from the Hawks. UMES trying to avoid their fifth straight loss. FAMU trying to win for the first time all year on the road. Bernard passes to the left side and Bowman tend to shoot. Circles to the paint. Backdoor pass bobbled. Johnson on the baseline. Had it jarred loose. Tip near the three-point line. Bernard fakes. Puts up a triple and cans it with two on the clock. Man, what a roll that found the way for Florida A&M. That ball had several chances to not go their way on the rebound.
The Hawks got a hit twice that time. Unlucky bounce of the ball for the Hawks.
77-74, Florida A&M. A bobbled pass up top and a turnover. Johnson goes to work on Rivera. Finds a trailing teammate and he throws it away. It's kicked out of bounds off a Hawk. A little sloppy here the first minute and 8 seconds of overtime number two.
That's why we're in overtime, too. Nobody wants to take charge of this basketball game.
Florida A&M hit 9 of their first 13 three-pointers. Since then, they've hit 1 of 9. 10 of 22 from distance tonight. Mark Seelin back in the game. Each team in the double bonus here late as both Rivera and Andino check out. Blackman, Seelin, Copeland, Martin, and Peck are out there.
Coach Collins trying to find somebody to take care of the basket.
A bad pass into the paint. Martin picks it away for the Hawks. He goes all the way up the floor. Euro steps his way into the lane and finger rolls it home. 77-76, Hawks down one. What an exciting game here at home. Third to the last regular season game of the year. The home finale comes on Saturday against rival Delaware State. How you gonna do better than this? Bernard on the left baseline from 12 feet finds Johnson cutting the basket. Stripped away by Peck. Blackman picks it up. He's pressed in the backcourt. Finds Martin, who turned it over on the right wing. And right at the midcourt stripe, it's a jump ball and two Florida A&M.
Rattlers ball.
I mean, both of these teams right now are just a little bit antsy, trying to play out of their mind.
It's called tight. Unbelievable tight. Having trouble holding on to the basketball. It's like a hot potato out there.
All I can say is the Hawks are probably glad this is a home game and not a road game.
You're right.
Because the crowd is on their side. Bowman through the right side of the paint, fading away from the basket, missed the layup. Florida A&M has self-destructed with missed layups late and in crucial moments. Martin feeds Seelan up top to Blackman on the left wing. Blackman hasn't scored in 15 minutes, but he has been a pest with four steals tonight. On the left side, Bakari Copeland. A great handle through the legs. Bumped in the lane. No call. Out of bounds. Stays with the Hawks. Blackman ties his career high with four steals this evening. Andino and Shane Randall come off the bench. We haven't seen Randall in forever. Peck and Blackman sit down. Nine to shoot for the Hawks. 2:47 left in our second overtime. UMES trails 77-76. Randall on the inbound. He falls into the backcourt. Saves it just in the nick of time. To Martin, who pulls up top of the key. Hits it. Hawks have the lead 78-77. Walking on pins and needles.
He's got his saves by about an inch.
The length, less than that, it was the length of his shoelace.
I thought, though, it was a good save.
Johnson, top of the arc. Looks left, passes right. Bernard finds Ravenel in the corner. 12 to shoot. From the left side, Johnson looking around. 2:15 to play. A.J. Johnson threw it away underneath. Overshot. Bernard under the basket, and Johnson has to get his head straight.
How about that pass?
The Hawks surrendered a three-point bucket to start overtime number two. They were down three, but since then, they've scored twice. 2:05 to play in our second overtime. Martin from just the top left side of the floor, circles to the right elbow, stops and pops and puts it up and in. 80-77. Devin Martin has 24 tonight.
And he's taking over the game, Brendan.
The senior has manned up late, even though his left leg was cramping at the end of regulation. Hawks by three, game-tying three, left wing is in and out. Martin grabs the rebound off the Ravenel miss.
He's doing it all. He's scoring the points, he's playing the defense, he's grabbing rebound.
1:35 to play. Each team has one timeout. Devin on the right side gets a screen from Randall. Dribbles to the top of the circle. We are in our 49th minute of basketball as Martin's three is too long. Copeland chases down the board. 1:19 to play. They give it to Seelan.
Oh,
Mark Seelan up top to Bakari Copeland. They could kill a lot of time here.
Yes.
But if the Hawks get a basket, that could be monumental. Seelan with 15 to shoot, 1:05 to play. Goes to the left. Looks for Copeland in the key. Hawks up three. And an offensive foul on Shane Randall on the backside of the play. That was the worst thing the Hawks could do. Fourth foul on Randall.
Who again is... What'd he do, right? Back screen over there? We were watching a play down here to the left.
It was an illegal screen on the back half of the floor. Randall stays in the game. Bakari Copeland sits down. Derek Opeck checks in. Four fouls on Copeland, four on Randall, four on Peck. Elliott has already fouled out. 1 minute to go. Hawks are up by three. As opposed to the end of regulation and overtime number one, when A&M had chances to win it, they missed a layup at the end of regulation and a jump shot from the left elbow at the end of the overtime number one. Johnson fakes, drives down the middle, put it in, and one! Johnson went into Randall. He is fouled out of the game, and Johnson may have just redeemed himself.
That was a tough shot there.
80-79, and Randall's day is over. 44 seconds left in the game. Let's see. They make a couple substitutions, it looks like. Andino, Rivera, Martin, Copeland, and Peck will be on the floor. I don't know if Shane realizes he's done.
It's far.
Yep. There he goes. Wow. Unbelievable. So Johnson steps to the free throw line. 27 minutes for Johnson tonight. He's 5 of 8 from the stripe, just 1 of 6 from the floor. This would tie the game at 80. The shot is up and short. Oh, my gosh, he missed it. 13-second difference between game and shot clock with the Hawks up 1. FAMU doesn't want to foul. Devin trips but keeps possession. Up top to Rivera. Oh, my gosh, he tripped over his own 2 feet. We've got 25 seconds left. The Hawks lead by 1. They've got to get a shot off in 10 seconds. Rivera between the circles. 20 seconds left in overtime number 2. 80-79. 3 to shoot it. Copeland checks the clock. Has to force. He didn't get it off. You've got to be kidding me. Wow. UMES, 3 different times offensively tonight, has totally lost it in critical situations offensively. They just haven't closed the game.
That was seriously critical there.
Hawks lead by 1, and Florida A&M, with 13.5 seconds left, will have the ball and a chance to win it on the final shot if they so choose. Here's Bowman. Bowman across midcourt, 10 seconds to play. Everybody on their feet. Top of the arc. Goes to work. He lost the handle. Picked it up. Chucked it up. He put it in!
Yeah.
2.6 on the clock. You gotta be kidding me. 81-80. Bowman almost kicked the ball. He is out of his mind, jumping around. His teammates are all over him at midcourt. Timeout, Hawks. It's 81-80.
Holy mackerel. There's been some shots down there. Wow. He almost lost it twice. Grabbed it, just jumped up and chunked it, and that bad boy went in.
It didn't even hit the rim. It was as pure a shot as he's put up all night.
Nothing but net. That was probably, the purest shot that they've hit.
25 points for Bowman in 45 minutes. And some of the fans are starting to make their way to the exit, which is disappointing because the Hawks will get a shot here, or at least an opportunity for one. Down 81-80 with 2.6 seconds left. UMES has burned their final timeout. Florida A&M is trying to win their first road game of the year. This would be their most emotional win of the season, and it wouldn't even be close. The Hawks are trying to avoid their 5th straight loss in conference. The Hawks are 5-8. Rattlers are 3-9 in the MEAC. And again, with no postseason play for Florida A&M, this is everything for them. They've only got a couple games left.
There must be a lot of non-basketball people in here because anything could happen now. This baby's not over.
So the Hawks draw up the play they want. No Elliott, no Randall. And I think the officials are going over to check the monitor. They must want to make sure that the scoreboard has the right time on it. I mean, this has been as emotional a game as you're going to see. It's certainly been the most thrilling all season. Two teams that just haven't played very well this year. They've both had struggles. They clearly both have talented players. They just haven't been able to string it together.
And they played very, very hard.
And it's sometimes too hard, out of control. Yeah. And you know, the athleticism was never the question. They have shown the ability to make plays. But
we've seen some shots.
Yeah, this has been a wild one tonight. The Hawks on the ladies' side picked up a big-time win over Florida A&M earlier this evening. And a hearty congratulations to them in that win. Fred Batchelor's group with 4 straight wins for the first time this year. They're over 500 in conference play with 2 to go as well. They're now 8-6. On the men's side, the Hawks can finish as high as 8-8 in conference play. And their best possible standing in the conference is 4th place, which is important. That's an outside shot, but if you make 4th place, you get a first-round bye.
That's important.
It's very unlikely at this point, but it's possible.
Yeah.
Anything's so they put additional time on the clock.
Anything's possible.
That's right.
We've seen that tonight.
You bet. 3.2 on the clock. The Hawks down 81-80. And as soon as they come out on the floor, Florida A&M, with a little gamesmanship, they call a timeout. They had it. They figured, okay, we'll see how they come out and line up. And then we'll make sure we drop the right defensive play.
We're going to get a shot at it with 3.2.
Well, the question is, are you going to get a good shot, or are you going to have to force something? And if you're Florida A&M, you better play good defense, because if you get sloppy, we have seen tonight several times where, you know, those questionable kind of ticky-tack foul calls, it's been called all night.
That can happen.
So we'll see. 81-80, Florida A&M by one on Craig Bowman's potentially game-winning jump shot here in the end of our second overtime. K.J. Johnson had a chance to win it in regulation and missed a layup through a wide-open left side of the paint. Then it was Bernard that missed the jumper to win the game at the end of overtime number one on the left elbow. Copeland will inbound. He's got the chance to run the baseline with Peck, Martin, Rivera, and Andino. Bakari reaches down to tie his shoe. 3.2 left. The Hawks down 81-80. Waiting on Copeland's shoelace. Needs 1 second, and we're ready to go.
I don't know why it's so far.
Here we go. They're not going to guard the inbound. Copeland looks, got to get it in. Finds Devin Martin. Devin races up from the middle of the free throw line. I don't think he got it off, but it didn't matter. The shot didn't go. Martin tried to get a high percentage look close to the basket, but he couldn't get it off in time. The basket didn't go anyways. And the final score today in double overtime, UMES loses to